great. He's got a .625 batting average against. And just like Utley, he's leading it off for the Diamondbacks.
Third base coach for the Dodgers, Chris Woodward. He played in the big leagues, as did the first base coach, George Lombard. Dave Roberts in his first season as the Dodgers skipper. The home plate umpire tonight is Carlos Torres. Brian Knight is at first base. Sam Holbrook at second, and the crew chief, Jerry Davis, is down at third. Defensively, the Diamondbacks have Peter O'Brien on left field. David Peralta in center tonight, his second start in center field since coming off the DL. And the right fielder is Yasmani Tomas. Jake Lamb's at third. Nick Ahmed at short. Gene Segura at second base. Paul Goldschmidt at first base. And the battery, Wellington Castillo catching, right-hander Zack Greinke. So we're set for a night of baseball. In fact, three games here. Tonight, tomorrow night, same time, and then Wednesday afternoon at 12:40. As the Diamondbacks then take off on a road trip that will take them to Philadelphia, Toronto, and Denver. Chase Utley will step in, lead things off. He's playing a lot, playing second base on a regular basis these days. .268 average, four home runs, 20 runs batted in. And he's hitting .312 on the road. He and Gonzalez have really been raking on the road for the Dodgers. He stands in, Greinke into the windup, first pitch of the night. And it's a little bit outside, said Carlos Torres, ball one.
Fastball just missed the outside edge, 90 miles an hour. But you look at Utley, you know, he's really had a resurgence with the Dodgers.
Left-handed hitter, they got him from the Phillies during the 2015 campaign. That's a strike call right at the bottom of the zone. 1-1, 98 degrees as we play with the roof and panels open. But for that air conditioning, they've been running all day. It's nice and cool inside as we speak. Crowd still making its way in. The Dodgers come in here, two games above 500. That's the ball, 2-1 now. Boy, it must be a real tight zone here for Carlos Torres.
I agree with you. That was a changeup at 87, but it was right there. Greinke looked in there, expecting to get a call, but according to Fox Tracks, it's outside.
So our eyes are not as good as we thought.
Well, you know how would I feel about Fox Tracks all the time.
Here's the 2-1 pitch on the way to Utley. And he swings and misses. And the count, 2-2. Greinke's got a dandy changeup. Fastball, he can locate anything he wants pretty much at any time.
I think the two pitches that really, for me, make him stand out are the slider command along with the changeup. When he gets those two combination of pitches going, that's when he gets hitters eating out of his hands.
Utley takes strike three call and a late call by Carlos Torres, and Utley just hesitates and now heads back to the dugout, one down.
Great pitch, a slider after all those pitches. He comes in with the slider on the inside edge. First time he threw the ball inside, and he gets the punch out.
So one out, that'll bring up Corey Seager, the shortstop. Seager, outstanding rookie who came up last year and got everybody excited in Dodger blue. .280 average, 14 homers, 35 driven in, and he fouls one back out of play, and that is strike one. This kid's going to be good for quite some time since May 7th. He has recorded 12 home runs. That's the most in the major leagues. He's got 14 on the year.
Boy, didn't he have like about six in 1 week?
Yeah, he had five in two games. There's a pitch, and that's popped up foul. Lamb gives chase the third baseman. That's going to get back and out of play, strike two. Of course, his brother Kyle plays for the Mariners. He's having a decent year after a slow start. Pretty talented family they've got. One out, nobody on, a strikeout of Utley to start the ballgame. And Seager is of the new age shortstop. At 6 feet four, that bounces by Castillo, the backstop, and then right back to Welly. Count is now 1-2. Used to be all the shortstops were about 5'10", 5'11", or even shorter.
They could field and run.
Yeah, nowadays they're all 6'2", 6'3", 6'4", or more.
And thump.
Yep. 1-2 count on Seager, on deck Turner, one out. Here's a pitch from Greinke, and that misses low and in. And the count will even up at 2 balls, 2 strikes.
Well, this is one of the things that Zack likes to do, is if the guys will not chase his slider like Seager has not, he comes in with the changeup. Down and away, either gets a strikeout or he gets him to roll right over the top of it.
Here's a windup and the 2-2 pitch, and it's outside. Ball three, 3-2 now.
Changeup that time he didn't chase, a little off the plate away. But he loves that combination of pitches.
Outfield plays Seager straight away. Peralta playing very deep out in center. A 3-2 pitch coming from Zack Greinke, and it's lined to right, and that's a base hit. So Seager's base hit to right field on a 3-2 count. The Dodgers have the first base runner of the evening, and that'll bring up Justin Turner.
Well, just in that at bat, he shows the kind of talent that he has. Saw all those pitches, missed a couple fastballs up in the zone, laid off a changeup or two, a slider down, and then he just whacked that ball to right field.
Turner hitting .221, 5 homers, 21 runs batted in, but in his last 22 games against the Diamondbacks, a .339 average. Last night here at Chase Field, he's at .367. Teams usually come in here, if they're not swinging the bats well, they like the backdrop here in the hitter's ballpark. And their eyes light up. There's a stretch by Greinke, and the first one to Turner is hit to center. He smoked that ball. Going back on his Peralta at the wall, and he has it get off the wall and go by him. Here comes Seager around third. He's going to be waved to the plate, and he will score without a throw. And it's 1-0 Dodgers on a line drive double off the wall in center by Turner. And Peralta got a little too close to the wall there.
Yeah, David didn't play that ball well, but I think he was hoping he had help behind him. Yasmani was going over there, but not in any kind of emergency or urgency. And finally he retrieves the ball, but a little bit too late.
So that snaps a string of scoreless innings for Greinke, who had come into this one with 16 scoreless innings. Second longest active streak in baseball behind the Tigers' Michael Fulmer, who's at 28 and a third. A first inning run here on a one-out single and an RBI double, and that brings up Adrian Gonzalez, who has always hit the Diamondbacks, whatever uniform he's worn. Left-handed batter. .279 average, 6 homers, 31 driven in. He hits a hard ball on a hop to Segura, the second baseman, who fields and throws to Goldie for the out. And on the play, Turner goes to third.
He wasn't waiting around either. He jumped on that first pitch and smoked that ball hard, but Segura was right there.
So runner at third with two outs, and that'll bring up Trace Thompson. Thompson, acquired from the White Sox in the offseason, playing on an everyday basis now. And you'll know why with his numbers. 10 home runs, 23 runs batted in. He can run. He's a very good athlete. His brother right now playing for the Golden State Warriors, trying to win a championship tonight, beating Cleveland. As we speak, first pitch is a strike call 0-1. And a very talented father who played in the NBA for a lot of years, Michael Thompson. Quite a family.
Pretty good bloodline,
yes,
right,
sir.
There.
A run in, a runner at third, two men out against Greinke, who's working in the full windup here. Diamondbacks have a shift on the left side. The pitch to Thompson bounced up there. Knocked down by Castillo. Turner about a quarter of the way down and now hustles back to third. As Castillo scrambles to the baseball. One ball, one strike. Thompson's a big kid, 6'3". And his hot bat has got him a regular spot in the everyday lineup these days for Dave Roberts. One ball, one strike count. The pitch from Greinke. Foul back to the screen, and now it's 1-2.
Zack has been getting a lot better with runners in scoring position. Early in the season was not real good, but he's got it all the way down to .273. And he's only given up 5 extra base hits in those situations. So he has really made a great effort of being a great situational pitcher here lately.
Started the ballgame with a strikeout, but then a single by Seager on a 3-2 pitch. An RBI double by Turner. Scored Seager. Turner's at third, two down. The 1-2 to Thompson is into the dirt. Knocked down again by Wellington Castillo. Two balls, two strikes.
Another good block with a guy on third base. You don't want to have a wild pitch right here or a pass ball.
Turner was a second-round pick in 2009. It was a three-team trade between the Dodgers, White Sox, and Reds that landed L.A. this young man. Down the line is Turner at third. Greinke steps off the rubber. Zach's thrown 17 pitches in this first inning. He's allowed a run. He's got a runner at third with two men out trying to retire Thompson. On the 2-2 pitch, and it's a check swing. He held up in time. Just in time, 3-2 now.
Boy, good pitch, good slider. Almost went.
Ryan Knight, first base umpire, said he held up just in the nick of time. Full count. So the second 3-2 count on a hitter for Greinke in the first. Seager Got him for a single and then scored. Here's the 3-2 on the way, and that's outside. He walked him ball four. So a two-out walk, first and third now for the left-handed hitting Jack Peterson.
Thompson saw that slider out of Zach's hand like he knew it was coming that time. Laid off of it. Draws the walk.
Peterson, 227, but nine home runs, 27 driven in. He gave the Dodgers their lone run last night in a loss to the San Francisco Giants. He had a tremendous first half of his rookie year last year, made the All-Star team, but really slumped after. 164 in his last 14 road games. First pitch to him is a little bit low. One ball, no strikes. Greinke looked in there like he wanted that pitch. Didn't get the call.
That was a changeup almost in the dirt.
So the Dodgers have struck first here. They've got a shift on the right side of the infield. And they keep Lamb over at third. Out of the stretch of the pitch, and it's popped up. Backing out is Lamb, the third baseman, and Jake's got it in fair territory. Behind the third base, back to end the inning.
But then relax as the roof opens for a post-game fireworks spectacular presented by Gila River Casinos. Visit dbacks.com.
Listen to Arizona Sports anywhere with the Arizona Sports app. Download it now in the Google Play Store or Apple App Store.
Bottom of the first inning, Dodgers strike first with a run. They send out Mike Bolsinger, who's 1-3 this year, a 5.75 ERA, four-pitch pitcher, fastball, curveball, slider, and a very occasional changeup. Does not have overpowering stuff, loves his breaking stuff. Command is a little bit shaky, and he's given up a lot of home runs this year, five home runs in 20 and a third innings pitched.
Gene Segura will step in. Segura's 5-for-8 in his career against Bolsinger with a pair of triples. 1-0 Dodgers here in the first. First pitch on the way. And Segura hits it to center field. Backing up on it is Peterson at the warning track. And he's got it. One pitch, one out. Well, he hit it hard. He hit it high. He hit it deep, but it was an out.
He was sitting on a fastball, and he got it that time. One of the few that Bolsinger will throw, and just missed it.
Jake Lamb the hitter now. Lamb the Diamondback third baseman. It is Van Slyken left. Peterson who just caught that ball in center. Thompson to right. Turner, Seager, Otley, Gonzalez third to first on the infield. And they shift. They leave Turner on the left side by his lonesome grand dog catching Mike Bolsinger. Bolsinger's start against the Rockies June 6. Kerr Hightine six runs. Seven hits and five and a third innings. Got the loss 2-1. One ball, no strikes on Lamb. Jake, 262 average, 11 home runs, 38 runs batted in. The 1-0 to him. And a breaking ball stays upstairs, 2-0.
That was the hanger right there, a high curveball about letter high.
Now they're going to shift. Turner's going to go to the right side, and Seager's going to go to the left side.
Musical chairs. Musical positions.
Everybody does it differently, I guess. Here's a 2-0 pitch to Lamb with one out. Jake takes a strike, 2-1.
Well, if you're going to have one guy on the left side of the infield, it's got to be your shortstop. You know, unless your shortstop, unless your third baseman is a guy like Arenado or Machado.
Lamb swings and misses. Another breaking ball, 2-2.
Going to get a steady diet of those and sliders.
They're going to keep coming. Jake out of the box, back in. Been in the two spot the last couple of games. Been batting some cleanup. Bolsinger shook one off. Now back to work in the 2-2 pitch to Lamb. And a line drive to right, but there is Thompson going over, and he makes the catch. A couple of hard hit balls here off Bolsinger, but both have resulted in outs.
Nice swing by Jake Lamb that time on a curveball, a little bit inside. A little bit down, but he stayed on that ball, hit it well, but Thompson was right there.
Here's Goldie. Now we talk about Gonzalez, his career numbers against the Diamondbacks. Goldie's been that way against the Dodgers. When he has a chance to play against them, 330 average since 2011. 20 doubles, 22 home runs, 65 runs batted in. And he takes a strike up and in, 0-1. The home runs, 22. The RBI, 65. Most against the Dodgers since August of 2011. 9 more home runs than Carlos Gonzalez has hit. And 21 more RBIs than Justin Upton had. There's a high fly ball into deep right center field. Back goes the center fielder, Peterson, and it's gone. A home run for Goldie into the pool area, and this game is tied at 1. His 12th of the season, RBI number 40.
I got a feeling this ball is going to be carrying tonight. I didn't think Goldie got all that one, but it just kept going. Peterson gave it a great effort. Couldn't come down with it.
Yeah, Peterson has robbed some hitters of home runs on leaping grabs. That glove over the wall, this time he didn't have enough. Didn't have enough arm length, didn't have a big enough glove. In fact, he crashed into the wall before he could really extend it. And a home run for Goldschmidt ties his ball game at 1.
Yeah, he got a little too close to the wall that time.
Good now's David Peralta. Well, you just talked about Bolsinger in the home run ball, and Goldie gets him in the first inning, 3 batters in.
He has given up at least 1 home run in every one of his starts. And then one of them he's given up 2.
So the D-backs get the run right back. 1-0 pitch to Peralta. Taken for a strike. 1-1. And there goes Turner back over to the right side. And Seager goes back over to the left side in the shift. Here's the windup by Bolsinger and the pitch to Peralta. And a little flare in the center. That'll be a base hit. Peralta, a sharp turnaround first. He'll hang on there.
Didn't get it real well, but he got it good enough. Just a little dubber into center field. Half-line drive, he'll take it. That's a base hit. That's a base runner.
And that'll get Castillo to the plate. Castillo, his bat's starting to pick it up of late. 346 over his last 7 ball games.
And as we were talking this last series, he needs to start driving the ball. He is getting some base hits. But you want to see him just torching that right center field gap.
He had one right off the very end of the bat yesterday that went by first base. Got him a run batted in. First pitch here, he starts with a breaking ball as Bolsinger gets it in for a strike on 1. So 1-1 here in the first inning. RBI double by Turner. Home run by Goldschmidt. Brawled at first, 2 down. Bolsinger's ready. And the pitch to Castillo. Fastball runs inside. The hit by Goldschmidt, the home run, the first of the game by the Diamondbacks, brought to you by Hayward Pools. Remember, if a ball is hit in the pool, you can win $2,000 cash. Text cash to 620-620 to enter to win. The pitch to Castillo, breaking ball and a wave and a miss. I call that a wave, not a swing, 1-2.
I'm with you.
Big old breaking ball. Well, Bolsinger, he'll just keep throwing them. That's what he likes to throw. They play Castillo straight away. They play him deep. Peterson now in a few steps in center. 2 strikes on the hitter. Here it comes on 1-2. And instead, Bolsinger steps off. Let's pause here for station identification. Diamondbacks Radio Network.
Arizona Sports on 98.7 FM.
A 1-2 count on Wellington Castillo, the Diamondbacks catcher. And that fastball is a strike on the inside corner. Got him looking, and this inning is over. 1 run, a home run by Goldie, 2 hits in the inning. Man left on base, and after 1 completer, Diamondbacks. Goldie tied it with a home run into the pool area and the bottom of the first. So here on the second, bottom of the order, Grandal, Van Slyke, and Bolsinger. Grandal hitting only 191, 5 homers, 20 RBIs, but normally hits well against the Diamondbacks. And especially here in this ballpark, he takes a breaking ball strike from Greinke. Grandal, a switch hitter. Batting left-handed against the right-handed offerings of Greinke. Here's the 0-1 pitch to him. Fly ball into right center. Going over Tomas. And Yasmani makes the catch. And there's one away. That ball almost more suited for Peralta, but Yasmani made the call, and David let him take it.
Yeah, David had a little word with him right there, but that's completely David's ball out there. Yasmani went a long ways to catch that ball.
Here is Scott Van Slyke, their left fielder. Scott Van Slyke's been so disappointed since the Diamondbacks traded Wade Miley. He had ownership of Wade. didn't he?
Big time.
First pitch is foul back, strike one.
And he knew it, and Wade Moot knew it also.
It was one of those matchups that just did not favor the former D-back lefty who's now in Seattle. No balls and a strike on Van Slyke. His daddy was a really good ball player for a lot of years, Andy Van Slyke in the big leagues. That ball is down low, one ball, one strike. Van Slyke missed some time on the DL with a lower back irritation. He was reactivated June 3rd. He had 8 outfield assists last year. And that's a strike. Well, his dad was a Gold Glove winning outfielder. It could
a lot of
really
assists.
Run him down, yeah. The count is 1-2 on Scott Van Slyke. One ball, two strikes. Scoreboard is not working correctly at the moment. For those of you here. Here's the fly by Greinke on the 1-2 of Van Slyke into right field. That ball's sailing. And that ball will go off the wall. Peralta's got to track it down. And Van Slyke will stop at second with a double. Get back in. And he barely got in at second base.
Goldie almost snuck up behind him and got the ball. And almost got the tag on his foot before he stepped back on the second base bag.
I think Van Slyke thought that ball was out of here the way he was reacting. It hit off the fence, nowhere close to being out. Peralta had to play the ricochet, and then the quick throw back, and he did get back, beat the tag of Goldie. That's a double.
Yasmani went back on that ball, but ball almost hit him in the back of the neck. Just went over his glove, but his back was turned. He didn't really have a good look at the ball. And they get the ball back in, and Van Slyke was thinking, probably would have had a triple. He was thinking about three, but I'm with you. I think he thought that ball was out.
Now Greinke runs in from the mound and meets Castillo about halfway between the mound and the plate. Talk things over. Bolsinger is a hitter. He is 0 for 6 with 4 strikeouts this year. On deck at Sutley. So that's hit number 3 against Greinke. And their second extra base hit, their second double. Here's the first one to Bolsinger. Going to swing, and he does, and swings through it. Strike one. Mike's out of Chicago, makes his home now in McKinney, Texas. Grew up in the shadows of Wrigley Field. 0-1 the count. Here's a pinch, and that is a strike. 0-2 from Greinke. Just pounded the zone here with a pitcher up. We're in the second. Each team got a run in the first inning. Dodgers threatened with a runner at second. And one man out here. In the top of the second off Greinke. That one is outside. That's a slider that missed. Bolsinger did not swing. 1-2. Tomorrow night, Archie Bradley against Kenta Maeda in game 2. And then Wednesday, a couple of lefties, Patrick Corbin and Clayton Kershaw, go at it. That's 12:40 game. Ball two strikes. Greinke checks Van Slyke. And that's strike 3 call. Bolsinger was ready to go back to the dugout before the umpire called it strike 3. He knew it was a strike.
He got buckled on a slider. He had a couple big swings at a fastball, nothing, but the slider started coming on the inside part of the plate. He gave up on it and then watched it break right over the middle.
Now with 2 outs, Greinke's got to go up against the veteran Chase Utley. He struck out to open the ballgame. Struck him out looking. Seager moves out on deck. So now that runner in scoring position, but with 2 outs. Utley taps his cleats with the bat. Now pounds his bat on the plate. Stares out at the pitcher, Greinke. He really doesn't have a stance until that pitcher is ready to go. And the first pitch to him is taken low and inside, ball 1-1-0. Just kind of slides the bat into his hand. And really, when that pitcher's in the windup, he's taking a semi-practice swing. He's always done that. A lot of years with Philadelphia 13. It was Utley, Howard, and Rollins for a lot of years. That trio has been broken up. Utley's the only one getting any playing time right now. Howard's on the bench in Philadelphia. Rollins was recently designated for assignment by the White Sox. There's a fake back to second by Greinke, and Van Slyke goes back to the bag. That was a pretty good trio for a lot of years.
Some good Phillies teams they had.
Yep. Dudley has one hand at the bottom of the bat, another hand about halfway up. Now he sets. The pitch from Greinke is a strike call. 1-1. Well, with Dudley at the plate here, word out of San Francisco is the Giants are either close to a deal or have come to a deal with Ruben Tejada, who Muntley took out in that slide last year in that series with the Mets during the postseason. Tejada recently released by the Cardinals. Here's a 1-1, and that's back to the middle. Knocked down by Greinke. Scrambles for it. Picks it up, throws to Goldie to get the out to retire the side. No runs, a double, a man left. We'll go to the bottom of the second inning. It'll be O'Brien. .com. Check out Milgard Windows and Doors for your home. O'Brien hit a blast here yesterday. A three-run shot of the first inning where the Diamondbacks got four. First one to him. Breaking ball, and he hits this one a mile in the air. Deep left field. Going back on it, the left fielder Vance Slyke, and right in front of the wall, he's got it for the out. If he'd have hit that ball on the line, it might have gone through the panels out there.
He's got that kind of power. That ball was up there. He just missed it. My goodness.
Vance Slyke was laughing and saying something to Peterson, probably about the high hang time on that ball hit by O'Brien. One out, here's Yasmani, who is hitting .264. Seven home runs, 21 runs batted in. He's closing in on 200 at-bats on the year, now at .197. And he takes a strike. Bolsinger gets ahead of him. Yasmani has reached base against the Dodgers in 11 straight games, hitting .302 over that stretch. Here's the 0-1 pitch to him. And that's a strike, 0-2. On deck, it's Greinke in the eighth spot in the order. Quickly, the 0-2 pitch from Bolsinger. Grandal sets up way inside and runs the fastball in there, but didn't get the inside corner of the plate. No swing by Tomas, 1-2. We've seen Yasmani swing at that pitch from time to time, but he laid off there.
Well, we've seen Yasmani swing at a lot of pitches. Usually he gets in that swing mode and he can't stop himself.
He takes outside, 2-2.
It's like he's seeing the ball a lot better, though, right now off Bolsinger.
Well, with the addition of O'Brien now to the mix, the outfield a little congested these days. Outside, full count, 3-2. Peralta's back. They have lost Owings. You got Bourne, you got Weeks, so the hot hitters are probably going to be the guys who are in there playing night in and night out. Drury's in that mix also. So you want to play, swing the bat, get on base, drive in runs.
Produce.
Very simple. 3-2 pitch coming up from Bolsinger to Tomas with one out of the inning. Here it is. And a ground ball down to third. And a tough hop. Nice play by Turner. And then he throws across in time to get Tomas. Four out, number two.
That was almost like, look what I found. Did not play that ball well. It's that second hop, and he backed up on it, let the ball play him. And as that ball looked like it was going by him, he just stabbed at it and happened to catch it.
Here's Greinke. Zank's got eight hits and 29 at-bats. And some of the Dodger fans reacting here. Greinke not leading the club in hits. That belongs to Corbin, who's got 11. Now the Diamondback fans joining the chorus of cheers. Greinke's got a big smile on his face. And he hits one to center. He did well. Back on it goes Peterson. Back on it goes Peterson. And he's got it at the wall. Greinke gave it a ride, but Peterson tracked it down to the 4-13 mark. And the Diamond and a field VIP pass for the postgame concert for just $50. Limited in quantity. Visit dbacks.com/CornellVIP. Greinke will go up against Seager, Turner, and Gonzalez, 2, 3, and 4 in the order in the top of the third inning. It's all the Dodgers, 3 hits, Diamondbacks, 2. Dodgers have left 3 on base, Diamondbacks have left 1. First pitch of the inning, and Seager fouls it back. Seager ran the count to 3-2, second batter of the ballgame, and then lined a single to right field, then scored in the double by Turner in the first inning.
Zack wasn't real happy with that pitch. It was a changeup. Singer had a big hack at it. And just watching his facial expression, he was upset with where he threw that ball.
0-1 pitch. Fastball runs in. Makes him move his arms. One ball, one strike. Seager's out of Kannapolis, North Carolina. Born in Charlotte. First round, 18th overall pick in 2012. Swing and a miss. That was power against power there, and Seager didn't get it. 1-2.
Pretty much center cut fastball, 92. Missed it. And that's the value of throwing that changeup early.
One ball, two strikes. Left-handed batter. Pitch from Greinke. Down low. Seager last year got up in September, played in 27 games, had 98 at-bats. He hit .337, four home runs, 17 RBIs. And he played in all five of the Dodgers postseason games. In his major league debut last September 3rd. 2-2 pitch to him. Just off the outside corner. And another 3-2 count on Corey Seager.
Doesn't look like a rookie. He works the counts. He's got a lethal bat. He said he's going to be a good one for a long time.
Greinke's got the one he wants. Goes to work. 3-2 pitch. And it's ball four. He walked it. And that's the second walk given up by Greinke. And this is a leadoff walk to start the third inning.
Laid off that changeup and almost like he knew it was coming. That was a tough pitch. It was over the plate. It was just down.
That'll bring up Turner, who doubled to center, scoring Seager in the first inning. Seager's got one stolen base. Dodgers don't do a lot of running. Out of the stretch, check a Seager. Here's a pitch to Turner and a shot to center. It's another hit. Peralta charges. Seager will stop at second as the throw comes back in. Turner's seen two pitches and he's got two hits off Greinke.
Just jumped on that fastball and that was another laser shot. Zach's got his work cut out for him right now. He could use a double play.
And the batter will be Gonzalez, who grounded sharply to second his first time up.
Four hits already given up.
Plus two walks. A lot of base runners early on in this one against Greinke by his former club. Gonzalez, we mentioned, much better hitter on the road than he is at home. And he's always been a good hitter in this ballpark. 290 career hitter since his first full major league season in 06. Greinke out of the stretch, checks the runners. First pitch is a little low and away. One ball, no strikes. Gonzalez in his last 26 games in this ballpark is at .414 with 8 homers, 25 RBIs. .337 career average here. And leads active players with 34 home runs. He hits one off his foot. Out to the second baseman, Segura. That's a foul ball, dead ball, 1-1. 34 home runs all time against the D-backs. 107 runs batted in. 85 walks in 156 games.
Ooh.
He has never in his big league career been on the disabled list. And since 2006, he leads all major leaguers in games played, 1,650, counting tonight. Greinke looking for the double play ball, and that's a foul back, and the count now 1-2 on Gonzalez.
Ooh, good change up that time.
Trace Thompson's on deck.
A little bit out in front. Nice pitch.
Diamondbacks save it home with their first inning run, brought to you by Southwest Gas. Beer free this season. Call 811 before you dig to have underground utility lines marked for free. It's easy. It's the law. 1-2 count on Adrian Gonzalez. Seager walked. He's at second. Turner singled. He's at first. Nobody out in the inning. 1-1 in the third. Greinke to the plate. Swing and a miss. He struck him out. Greinke gets strikeout number three, and that's a big first out of this third inning.
Got him with the slider going down and in. Boy, nice pitch in a nice location.
Trace Thompson, the batter now. Thompson walked his first time up. 15th out of every game is brought to you by Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on your car insurance. Visit Geico.com or call 1-800-947-AUTO. We're at 13 outs. Greinke would like to get 2-for-1 here and make it 15 outs in this inning and this threat. First one to Thompson's a strike call, 0-1.
Thompson put a real good at-bat on him his first at-bat. He looked like he was seeing the ball really well out of his hand.
Washington behind Max Scherzer tonight beat the Cubs 4-1. Scherzer was working on a perfect game until Addison Russell hit a home run off of him in the sixth inning.
It's going to be a fun little series to watch.
Yeah. Here's the pitch, and Thompson takes it outside. One ball, one strike.
He looks like he's very selective.
Well, 145 at-bats for Thompson, only 35 strikeouts, and he's walked 19 times. Eight doubles to go along with 10 home runs, 18 extra base hits. He's got a couple of base runners against Greinke. With one out here in the third inning, a 1-1 game, the pitch. That's a strike. Greinke potted the strike zone there. Thompson had no answer for it. The count is 1-2.
Looked like he two-seamed this one right over the outside corner. Nice pitch. Came back just a hair.
The on-deck hitter, Jack Peterson. They give Thompson some room out there in left center. Greinke a long look in. Now Thompson calls and receives timeout. He backs out. And now steps back in. Greinke never left the rubber. Just stares in. Now he steps off, and now he wants to visit with Castillo. So they want to make sure they're on the same page here on a 1-2 pitch. And Castillo back to the plate area. Greinke back to the rubber. Zack is at 48 pitches. Working here in the third with one out and a couple of base runners. Count is 1-2 on Trace Thompson, the Dodger right fielder. Zack set. Here's the pitch, and it's off the inside corner, 2-2. Two balls, two strikes. Dodgers this year on the road are 16-17. Diamondbacks at home, 12-23, but they've won two straight. Trying to get this series off on a good note. Thompson swings and fouls it. He just got a piece of it. Stay alive over the plate, 2-2.
Another changeup. Zach's throwing a lot of changeups in this game so far. But Thompson in particular, he's making them work.
Seager started the inning on a 3-2 pitch walk. Turner hit the first pitch to center for a single. Gonzalez struck out swinging. And now it's 2-2 on Trace Thompson. Out of the stretch ready. Greinke delivers and a check swing. He went around, could not hold up. According to home plate umpire Carlos Torres, Thompson has some words before he heads back to the dugout. Greinke gets strikeout number 4 and 2 outs in the inning.
Another slider. Good location. Off the plate away. And that's a big strikeout. Get a couple guys on base. Looks like the Dodgers might have a chance for a big inning, and he comes back with two big strikeouts.
Now he's still got a tough hitter in Peterson, who fouled out to the third baseman. Lamb is first time up. Ahmed has moved over to the right side of the diamond. Lamb stays at third base. So that whole shortstop position is opened up for Peterson. He's hit 9 home runs on the air. First one to him here is popped up on the infield. Called for by Ahmed. And Nick's got it right behind the mound to end the inning. That's twice now Peterson's hit the first pitch and popped up to an infielder. The Dodgers, after a good start, 2 on to nobody. And it's 2 on in the first inning, 1 left on in the second, 2 left on in the third against him. Diamondbacks have really hit some balls hard against Bolsinger. One that got out, the home run by Goldie. First pitch here to Ahmed leading things off. Nick takes a breaking ball in for a strike. Ahmed on this homestand has gone 8 for 21. He went 5 for 11. And they just completed series the Diamondbacks had with the Marlins. He's gotten the batting average up to 221. Here's the 0-1 pitch to him. And that fastball runs in on the corner. And it's quickly 0-2. Bolsinger's gotten ahead. Nick has reached in 15 consecutive games against Los Angeles. 0-2 pitch to him. That's down low. 1-2 the count.
Well, Singer, not a hard thrower. Even that fastball was at 85 miles an hour.
Got a brown glove with blue string. 1-2 pitch. Upstairs. 2-2 the count. I guess they do anything with gloves anymore, huh? It's not a real good look.
You can go online and design your own if you wanted.
You'd be better off, I think, having an all-blue glove. Two balls, two strikes. Here's the pitch to Nick Ahmed. And he laid off in time. Full count, 3-2. Well, if you missed it earlier today, the Dodgers have released Carl Crawford. He signed a 7-year deal back in 2011, which took him through 2017. It's $142 million deal, making $20.75 million this year. And still owed $21 million next year. He's no longer a Dodger. 3-2 count on Ahmed, leading off the inning. The pitch from Bolsinger. And he struck him out swinging. Nick Cattigan caught in between there, and at the last second, thought it was going to be a strike, and he swung at it and was late and missed.
Emergency swing. Curveball inside. I think it's going to be off the plate in. Watching Grandal reaching all the way across the plate to try to catch that ball.
Second strikeout for Bolsinger. Top of the order in Segura. With the first pitch of the ball game to the wall in center, it was caught by Peterson. And that fastball runs inside. Ball one. We mentioned that James got good career numbers against Bolsinger coming in. He's now 5 for 9 with his 0 for 1 tonight. Couple of triples. The 1-0 pitch to him. And that's in for a strike, 1-1. Nice little breeze blowing through the ballpark. Another warm day here, but not as warm as it's supposed to be this weekend. They're saying maybe 120.
Oh.
Inside with a fastball, 2-1 in Segura. Diamondbacks will be in Philadelphia for a four-game series that will begin Friday and run through Monday. Friday through Monday, a wraparound series. Segura swings and fouls it into the mitt of Grandal for a strike, 2-2. Then we go up to Toronto for a couple of games, a night game and a late afternoon game. And then on to Denver to play the Rockies for four. So a four-game series with the Phillies, two with Toronto interleague, and a four-game set with the Rockies. Here's the 2-2 pitch. And Segura hits it foul to the on-deck hitter, Jake Lamb.
Kind of strange, two four-game series.
The Diamondbacks have not played in Toronto since the 2004 season. And that's the only time they've played in Toronto. Your old stomping grounds briefly.
Yeah, briefly.
Here's a wind by Bolsinger, the 2-2 to Segura. And a ground ball to short. Seager has it and fires across diamond to get Segura for out number two here in the third inning. Right now, it's the same old Bolsinger against the Diamondbacks. They have hit some balls hard, but only the two hits. Home run by Goldie, the single by Peralta. Here's Lamb, who lined out to right field in his first at bat.
The one thing you want to guard against is letting him settle into the game. When he gets into a rhythm and a tempo, that's when pitchers get tough.
They'll put a shift on for Lamb. Three on the right side of the infield. And they leave Seager on the left side. And there's a drive hit in the left center. That's pretty well struck off the bat of Jake Lamb. And this one will go. A home run. Opposite field blast by Lamb. And the Diamondbacks take a 2-1 lead.
That was a clinic on how to stay inside of baseball. Boy, that was a breaking ball, and he just shot it to the opposite gap. What a terrific swing.
Number 12 for Lamb. RBI number 39. He and Goldie now are dead even. 12 homers and 39 runs batted in between them. Actually, Goldie's got 40 with his home run tonight. So Jake Lamb, other way against Bolsinger, and shoots it out. Now Goldie, who homered his last time up, takes high here, ball one. Boy, Lamb, 12 home runs already. Game number 66 tonight. Getting better and better. 1-0 is on the outside corner to Goldschmidt.
Between Lamb and Goldie, you might have a couple guys hitting over 30 home runs.
Where they're going right now. On one pitch, Goldie takes a strike. 1-2. And the umpires behind the plate are disagreeing with Mr. Torres, the guy who's calling the balls and strikes.
I agree with the fans. That was a weak call.
1-2 count on Goldschmidt following the Lamb home run with two outs in the inning. The pitch way outside. 2-2. Cincinnati won that game in Atlanta 9-8 tonight. Ooh, White Sox come back big time against Detroit. 8-7 now, bottom of the sixth inning, Tigers. 2-2 pitch. Goldie swings, hits it to right. That's pretty well struck. Back is Thompson, and he's got it right in front of the fence. Goldie made a bid for a second home run. This one the other way. And Thompson flagged it down to win the inning. But Lamb gets the Diamondbacks on top with his 12th of the season, a solo blast. We'll head to the fourth. 2-1 D-backs do up. Zack has struck out four. He's walked a pair, given up four hits, and strike one to Grandal. Grandal fly to right field, his first at bat. Tomas is out and right tonight. Peralta's playing center, O'Brien in left. The 0-1 pitch from Greinke. And that's a strike, 0-2.
This is the inning you like to see Zack really settle down and, you know, get himself. We talk about it a lot, that you're getting into that rhythm, that tempo. You know, mixing your pitches up, you know, really pound the strike zone.
0-2 pitch and a ground ball to first. Goldie's got it. He'll take it to the bag himself. One out. You know, looking back, Andy, at what the Diamondbacks are doing against Bolsinger. They've hit the two home runs. They only have three hits, but Segura almost got one out. Lamb has homered. Goldschmidt has homered fly deep to right. Peter O'Brien almost got one out. And Zack Greinke almost got one out. They could have four or five home runs right now very easily.
Oh, real easily. Yeah, he's not fooling anybody.
Here's Vance Slyke, who doubled off the fence in right field his first time up. They put the shift on, three on the left side of the infield, and he pops it up to Goldie on the right side, who will be under it and makes a catch in fair territory for the out. And that's out number two. That's a one-pitch out right there, and Greinke's got to love that with Bolsinger, the pitcher, coming up.
Just what he needs right now. Have a quick, efficient inning and get the Dodgers back out on the field.
Bolsinger struck out looking in the second. First pitch on the way. Fastball strike on one. Zack said, here's a fastball. Hit it if you want. Adley, the on-deck hitter, the leadoff man. That's another strike, 0-2. Here's another fastball. Hit it if you can. 0-2 now on Bolsinger.
Yeah, let's see if he can hit this slider.
Here's a pitch from Greinke, and it's just off the plate. He came with another fastball. Attempted him, but
kept it off the plate.
Yeah, Bolsinger didn't swing. This next pitch will be Greinke's 60th of the night. And it's a swing and a miss on the slider, and he gets him, and that's five strikeouts for Greinke, averaging 15 pitches per inning. His bat's starting to show some vitality in it. He had a triple the other night. Got a sacrifice fly to the second baseman yesterday. He'll take the run batted in, but David off the DL, batting cleanup, first one to him. Is sliced foul down the left field line back into the seats out of play, strike one. It'll be Peralta, Castillo, and O'Brien against Bolsinger. And now Seager moves deep to short. He was playing in on that first pitch. He's all alone on the left side of the infield. Here's the 0-1 to Peralta. David takes it off the plate. One and one to come. Diamondbacks had a day earlier in this homestand where they really worked on bunting. A lot of the left-handed hitters bunting up that third baseline. David takes high and away from Bolsinger, 2-1. Bolsinger, a few times after he's thrown the baseball, has just kind of looked down at the ground and then kind of kicked the leg out. And the pitches have been way off the plate. 2-1 pitch here. Swing and miss on a ball in the dirt, 2-2.
Yeah, I think if you just have a little bit more of a selective approach against him, you can draw some walks. His command isn't all the way there, but he relies on a chase rate. He relies on guys chasing balls out of the zone.
He got Peralta to chase that one. David really wasn't close. Two balls, two strikes on him. Bottom of the fourth inning, 2-1 D-backs. Bolsinger to the plate. And Peralta chases a fastball and swings through it and strikes out. One down. He just carved him up on that a bit.
His last two pitches weren't strikes.
Nope.
And he ends up swinging for Sandy. You get a little over anxious and you're not selective. You chase those balls out of the zone. You strike out instead of maybe walking.
Shoulders drop. He hits back to the dugout. Bat in hand. Here's O'Brien, who hit one about a mile into the air that was caught right in front of the wall by Van Slyke in the first inning, or second inning, excuse me. Hitter homered here yesterday, his first of the season. Second big league home run. He hits this one down to third, but foul. Pass Matt Williams, third base coach.
Well, one thing we've known about Peter is that he likes to swing.
Yep.
Curveball again. That was going to be a ball, but I'll take that back. This is Castillo. O'Brien's
Castillo
on deck.
Yeah, O'Brien next. Yeah, the funny thing, too, is some of these swings have not been good against Bolsinger. They get other guys who just square the ball up, and the ball's been bouncing. Yeah, it's just been booming out of here.
When he's in the strike zone, he is vulnerable.
Castillo, his first time up, had a rough at bat. Striking out, looking. Bolsinger is fan three. And that pitch misses inside, 2-1 to count. Kind of a light schedule in baseball. The Giants behind Matt Cain, who came off the disabled list, are winning 2-0 at home tonight, second inning against Milwaukee. 2-1 to Castillo with O'Brien on deck. That's down low, 3-1 now.
Nice take on that time by Castillo. A curveball out of the zone. Doesn't chase it.
Well, maybe he'll get on for O'Brien, who's waiting.
That would be ideal.
Bolsinger kicks a little dirt off of the rubber. Now steps on. Goes to work in the 3-1 pitch to Castillo, and that's a strike. Took a fastball, 3-2. Well, that's the one you want to hit right there.
3-1, fastball count. You're looking for one pitch in one slot. If you get it, fire. And he just couldn't pull the trigger.
Full count now. And strike three call, and a late call by Carlos Torres. Castillo had thrown the bat away and was heading to first base when the umpire, Carlos Torres, called him out.
I guess Wellington thought this ball was low. Check on Fox Tracks. Right in the strike zone. At least the bottom part of the strike zone.
Really a late call, though. Two outs in the inning. I think it was a strike. It looked like it had the zone. But again, a very late call. Some of these umpires who do that exaggerated strike three call, they take a little time getting it out. That's been Torres' case tonight a couple of times. Now strike one to O'Brien. Peter's changed his number. I think he was wearing 72 last year, wasn't he? The old Carlton Fist number when he came up. And he's got 14 on now. There's the 0-1 to him. And that's, well, Grandal wanted the call there and didn't get it. One ball, one strike. Thought he had a pitch on the inside corner. O'Brien wears a guard on that front foot, the left foot. It's on the inside, so he must foul a lot of balls off. Ooh, he got tied up inside on that one. A fastball as Bolsinger handed up and in on him, 1-2 the count.
See, that's another swing and miss of a ball out of the zone. Just got to stay selective against this guy.
Two outs, nobody on. 2-1 Diamondbacks, fourth inning. The line by Bolsinger and the pitch to O'Brien. And it bounced up there, 2-2. First time in all year for the Dodgers. They'll be back in July, the 15th, 16th, and 17th, so just about a month. And then September 15th through the 18th, a four-game series. Two balls, two strikes on Peter O'Brien with two outs. The pitch from Bolsinger, and he struck him out of the breaking ball. And Bolsinger fans aside, Peralta, Castillo, and O'Brien. Well, that of the fifth, it's 2-1 D-backs.
There are only a few.
Four hits, two walks. Dodgers have left five on base against him. Greinke has struck out five. And Utley hits one down to first. That's a foul ball. Just foul. Would have been a nice, easy play for Goldie in a one pitch out, but it's a foul ball.
Well, it looks like the key right now for Zack is to control, you know, Utley and Seager, because Turner has really been having some good swings at him.
Double and a single. And he's hit the ball hard twice. That's a good fastball strike. 0-2 on Utley. Shift is on. And it's Ahmed who's backing up at short. Lamb on the right side of the infield. Leadoff hitter here in the fifth inning. Chase Utley against Greinke. And it's outside with a pitch. 1-2 now. Standings at the start of play today. The Giants leading these Dodgers by five games. The Rockies hanging around. They're 7.5 back. Diamondbacks 10.5. San Diego 12. Padres are 1-1 with Miami tonight. Third inning at Petco. 1-2 pitch. And it's sliced foul out of play. And that Miami ball club needing Giancarlo Stanton to get it going. Boras driven in the run tonight. That's Chen against Ray, Colin Ray. Will Myers is hot. He's hit another home run. It's 14th.
He is on fire.
Here's the 1-2 pitch from Greinke to Utley, who had just missed. 2-2 the count. Cincinnati beat Atlanta 9-8. Oldendorp beat Vizcaino. Cingrani is 7-save. Freeman hit his 10th. Garcia his 3rd for Atlanta. 2-2 to Utley. Is down to Goldie. He's got it. Greinke will cover. The underhand toss is good at the bag. One out.
Another good changeup. Gets an easy out to Goldie. Greinke's so agile over there. Very quick off the mound. And it's a nice, easy toss from Goldie.
And that Cincinnati win, Duvall hit number 18. He's having quite a season. Aaron Blair started that ball game, former Diamondback farmhand. Five innings, four hits, six earned runs with four walks and a homer. Now Seager swings and misses. Strike one. Corey Seager has singled. That was on a 3-2 pitch and scored in the first inning. Then he walked on a 3-2 pitch in the third against Greinke. 2-1 Diamondbacks lead in the fifth. The pitch. That's a strike. 0-2. Zach's come out of these first two hitters. Candy gone 0-2 on it.
Good combination of the changeup first pitch. Dot in the inside corner with the fastball the second pitch.
So an 0-2 count. A pitch to Seager. Into the dirt. 1-2. Philadelphia shut out Toronto tonight in Toronto. Eichhoff, the young kid, six innings, a three-hit ball, got the win. He beat Dickey, the knuckleballer. The knuckleballer must have not been knuckling tonight. Although he only gave up three of the seven runs. Here's a 1-2 pitch on the way to Seager, and it's outside 2-2. And again, in the first two plate appearances for Seager, he ran the count full before singling and then walking off Greinke. With one out, the 2-2 pitch. And a drive that's going to tie this one up. Way out and over the pool. Home run for Seager. It's 2-2. His 15th of the season. Came on a 2-2 pitch.
Boy, that ball was a blast. That goes into the no-doubter category. You said he's a big kid. 6'4 is a shortstop, but he got a hanging slider. Boy, he killed it.
So he has hurt Greinke tonight, and the guy that played has hurt Greinke tonight, and that's Justin Turner, who has doubled home, a run, and singled. It's a 2-2 game now. Fifth hit for the Dodgers on the night. One out as Turner steps in. Here's a windup by Greinke, and the pitch on the way. Swing and a miss, starting with a slider. So on one.
And Turner was in swing mode again.
And now ball's one strike. A 2-2 game here on the top of the fifth. Bounced up there. One and one. Long ball has been prevalent here tonight. Prevalent. With two for the Diamondbacks, Goldschmidt and Lamb, and now Seager for the Dodgers.
Got a feeling there's going to be a few more.
Yeah, the ball is moving. Gets up. Roof and panels open here tonight. A ball inside to Turner, 2-1 the count. That 4-1 Nationals win over the Cubs. Scherzer runs his record 8-4. Hendricks, the loser, 4-6. Kelly the save. Ramos hit number 10. Russell broke up the perfect game. The Cubs run. Scherzer 7 innings, 2 hits, 1 run, struck out 11. There's a drive to deep left by Turner. Back goes O'Brien, and at the wall he leaps, and he got it. Peter O'Brien, a leaping catch at the wall to rob Turner of a potential home run. What a catch by O'Brien at the wall.
Super catch that time, a high-hanging slider. Peter goes back, finds the wall, jumps up. Not sure if that ball was getting out of the park or not, but he made a nice play, robbing Turner of a hit.
He braced his hand against the wall and caught it. Turner hit that ball a long way, but out. Two down to the end of that catch, brought to you by the Colon Cancer Alliance. Colon cancer 90% beatable when caught early. Up to you to beat the odds. Learn more about getting screened for colon cancer at ccalliance.org. Now here is Adrian Gonzalez, and he skies one to center. And coming in on it is Peralta. He's there. He's got it. Seager's home run tied it. Turner's long drive almost gave the Dodgers a lead. We'll go to the bottom of the fifth in a 2-2 inning. And now back to work, Mike Bolsinger against Yasmani Tomas. Tomas fouls it back, strike one. Yasmani grounded to third in the second inning. Bolsinger has fanned five. He struck out the side in the fourth. Hasn't walked anybody. Only given up three hits. Tied with Greinke in this one halfway through. Here's the 0-1 pitch, and that's outside. And the count will even up. One ball, one strike. Tomas, Greinke, and Ahmed here. In the last of the fifth. There's a high fly ball left field. Going back onto this Van Slyke at the wall, and he's got it. We've had, I bet you, no fewer than a half dozen balls tonight that have almost gotten out, and three of them have gotten out.
I mean, again, their launch, that very high launch angle, and that ball's dying right about the fence.
Greinke hit one to the 4-13 mark near the pool that was caught by Peterson in his first at bat. He'll step in now, and the Dodger fans will boo, and the Diamondback fans will cheer.
That should be fun going to L.A.
Yeah. Well, he didn't pitch there last time, remember? But he wasn't, in fact, he wasn't introduced. They did not introduce the Diamondbacks reserves on opening day in L.A. But he'll pitch there before the year's over, I'm sure. One ball, no strikes on Zack. 8 hits on the year. And he takes upstairs, 2-0 from Bolsinger. I guess all the pitchers are getting into it now. Major League Baseball's even taking a look into maybe a home run derby for the pitchers.
Manager's nightmare.
Yeah. Two balls, no strikes. Here's a windup and the pitch. And that's a strike. It was funny, you know, it was Bumgarner, whose name was first mentioned, rightly so. Kind of pop he's got. Then Arrieta got in it. He's got a few home runs. He says, if he's going to be in it, I'm going to be in it. Now they're saying Jose Fernandez, Noah Syndergaard.
Wainwright threw his name in there.
Two balls and a strike. There's a check swing. Once again, Greinke does the point to first base, saying, check the umpire, make sure I didn't swing there. And the umpire agreed with it. 3-1. I get the biggest kick out of that one. Greinke's a batter, and he points on the check swing.
Well, he wants to do it before the home plate umpire calls a strike on him.
3-1 pitch, and that's a strike. 3-2. Greinke was heading to first, probably thinking, I'm not getting that pitch. How's he get that pitch? And he was right at the top of the zone.
Not even really inside.
3-2 now. Bolsinger ready. Pitch to Greinke on 3-2, and a shot to center, and that's a base hit. That ball was smoked. His ninth hit of the year.
Yeah, that ball was crushed. It's a high fastball and a great swing, a line drive right back where it came from.
You know, for a pitcher,
and a bat flip.
Yeah, for a pitcher and a guy who only sees. Well, he's a guy who goes into ball. He's going to see three at-bats each time he pitches, at least, for the most part. But for somebody who only goes up there every 5 days, he can really swing the bat. He knows what to do with it. Here's Ahmed, who struck out swinging in the third. Bolsinger out of the stretch, the pinch. Bounced up there. Greinke bluffs, but stays at first. One ball, no strikes on Nick. It's the fourth Diamondback hit of the night. So now Greinke has 9 hits. Corbin has 11. And Robbie Ray's got 6. Robbie at one time had 4 in a row. 1-0 the count here on Ahmed. That's down low. Ball 2, 2-0 from Bolsinger.
Well, the order works some magic here. Nick gets on base either by walk or hit. Flip it over for Segura, who's got the great numbers against him.
Remember on Saturday night, it was the bottom of the order, got it going. Michael Bourne, the home run off Fernandez, first base runner. And Diamondbacks went on to get 4 runs in the inning on 5 hits and beat him. 2-0 count here. Ahmed takes ball 3. As Grandal came up ready to fire to first, Greinke trots back to the bag. 3-0 count.
Throws him a 2-0 curveball that time. I guess he was playing off of Nick's aggressiveness. Well, you dug yourself a big hole.
Top of the order, and Segura next. The look in by Bolsinger. Greinke just got him for a one-out single after Tomas nearly missed the home run. The pinch, strike, 3-1 down. Wow, Miami's putting up big numbers now against San Diego. It's 7-1 in the third inning. Here it's 2-2. And a ground ball right side. Nice fielding play by Utley. They'll get the out at second, and that's it. As Greinke went in sliding hard to Seager. Nice play by Utley, who went to his left, dived for the ball, and then got on a knee and fired to Seager for the force on Greinke.
Made a really nice play. That ball was going into right field. Made a real nice play. Helped his pitcher out there.
Greinke runs pretty well. He might have tried to go to third if that ball gotten through. Instead, 2 outs, and now Rick Honeycutt to the mound for a visit with his pitcher. The batter is Segura. Gene tonight is 0-2. First time up, he sent Peterson to the wall in center to haul in his line drive out. Let's pause here for station identification on the Arizona Diamondbacks radio network.
KMVP, Phoenix, Arizona Sports on 98.7 FM.
2-2 in the fifth, game one of this three-game series. Archie Bradley, Kenta Maeda tomorrow night, and Patrick Corbin and Clayton Kershaw on Wednesday afternoon at 12:40. Let's see if Gene can get something done with two outs and a base runner. First one to him is a breaking ball away. 1-0 from Bolsinger. Ahmed, good speed over at first. Dodgers lead the all-time series with the Diamondbacks. 174 wins to 141. And they are 85-74 in this ballpark all time. 11 games above 500. Diamondbacks need to start turning that around.
Starts by just winning series.
Two outs, a base runner. Segura 1-0 count. The throw over to first and Ahmed back. End of the tag by Gonzalez. Milwaukee's come back with a couple of runs off Kane. They've tied that game with the Giants 2-2 in the third. Out of the stretch, and there goes the runner. Bounces away from Grandal. Ahmed belly flops into second and now has no chance to go to third. He was going to the pitch, so he'll get a stolen base, even though the ball went to the backstop.
Picked the perfect pitch to run on. Had a great jump on a curveball in the dirt. Grandal, getting up out of his stance, trying to backhand that ball so he can make a throw, was not able to catch it. And Nick, maybe with his head up, might have been able to round that and go to third.
So he's in scoring position. 2-0 count on Segura. When his career has hit Bolsinger well, but 0 for 2 tonight. See if he can get the Diamondbacks a lead back. And now time is called. Grandal is going to go to the mound. Baez is up in the bullpen for the Dodgers. Looks like J.P. Holland might also be up. Left-hander. Lamb is next. So if he got up this inning, you'd probably see a change. Howe would probably be brought in. I don't know any other reason they'd have him up. But for that. Segura trying to get on here, see if he can get Ahmed home from second and get the lead back for the D-backs in this 2-2 game in the fifth inning. Here's a pitch from Bolsinger. Inside, ball three, 3-0.
I can't imagine him pitching around Segura right here to face Lamb.
No. But he's fallen behind 3-0. He fell behind Ahmed 3-0. Ran to 3-1. Nick hit into a fielder's choice. He stole second. And now Bolsinger will go 3-0 against Segura. Two men out. 2-2 ball game. Last of the fifth. Here's a pitch. And that's a strike. 3-1. Kind of a high strike at that.
Gene thought it was a ball. He was ready to go to first base.
Bolsinger has yet to walk a man tonight. He's fanned five. Given up four hits. He's 2-2 in the game. The pitch is lined to center field. That's a base hit. Here comes Ahmed. Peterson throws into second. RBI single Segura. And the Diamondbacks have the lead back 3-2.
It was a breaking ball right over the middle of the plate. Gene in a nice count. Puts a nice swing on it and a shot to center field.
That's his 29th run batted in. Dave Roberts comes out. He'll go get the lefty now. Howe to face Lamb. Diamondbacks have gotten the lead back 3-2. We'll take a pitching change break. Call to the pen brought to you by Arnold Ford and Chandler Bull. In the fifth, 3-2 Diamondbacks lead the Dodgers on the D-backs radio network.
Loaded now in the Google Play Store or Apple App Store.
Jake Lamb, who homered in his last at bat, now facing the left-hander J.P. Howell, the veteran. A run in, 3-2 Diamondbacks here in the bottom of the fifth inning. The two-out single by Segura that scored Ahmed, who had just stole second base. Lamb steps in. His home run was his 12th of the season, 39 RBIs. And he faces the left-hander, J.P. Howell, trying to add another run. Howell is ready, and the first pitch instead goes to first base. $21,374 here tonight. First of the three-game series with L.A. We'll be here tomorrow night, 6:40, 12:40 on Wednesday. And now time is called. by the catcher, Grandal. His pace has slowed down some. The pitch. Strike call. 0-1.
Big curveball that time. Al's not a real hard thrower. He likes his off-speed pitches.
He was one of the big participants in that brawl in L.A. a few years ago.
Well, he had a license to swing. That's was running from the bullpen, and he was throwing haymakers.
And Turner Ward, who was with the Diamondbacks at that time, is now the hitting coach with the Dodgers. And Turner almost went over the railing in that melee. No balls and a strike. Howell is ready. Lamb digs in. Segura has laid the pitch. Runner goes. A swing and a miss. A throw down. And Segura is out on the tag by Seager going by. And that'll end the end. It's the fifth time that Segura's been caught this year. He's been successful seven times. Diamond giving up a home run. That was to Seager. First pitch here to Thompson. Hit in the air to center. And there is Peralta. One pitch and one out.
He'll take the outs, but a little bit unlike last game, Greinke's getting a lot of fly ball outs.
Yeah. So one out, and here is Peterson, who was fouled to land the third baseman and popped a shortstop. The two that have really hurt him in this game have been Seager and Turner. Seager's been on three times, scored a couple, hit a home run, and he scored on a double by Turner, and Turner's also singled and flied out to deep left field. So those are the two, three hitters in the lineup. This is Peterson batting sixth in the order, and Greinke starts him with a good fastball, 0-1. Zack looking for win number nine here tonight, trying to run his record to 9-3. Here's the 0-1 pitch, and that's just a little low, 1-1. Last win for Zack Greinke. That game against Tampa Bay was career victory number 150. He's what, one or two behind you?
One. Yeah.
Here's a chopper foul by Peterson that's grabbed by Grandal in the on-deck circle. 1-2. So right now he's in Mr. Candiani territory.
Got a feeling he'll be flying past me.
Zach's won five straight. Heading into this one tonight, facing his former team for the first time this year. Here's the 1-2 pitch. And that's slice foul back and out of play by Peterson. Greinke is 2-0 in his career and four starts against the Dodgers. Has not faced them since 2012 at Dodger Stadium. And he's played with Kansas City, Milwaukee, the Angels, and now with the Diamondbacks. And a high pop-up. Foul territory. Over goes Castillo and Goldie. That ball's behind the dugout. Boy, Peterson had that ball up. And he tommyhawked at it. Hit it over the first base dugout. It's 1-2.
That's how he got him out last time. Hit that pop-up to Ahmed, who ran in almost by the pitcher's mound and caught it. But it was a high fastball, and he went after that one also.
So 1-2 count on Jack Peterson. Grandal on deck. One out here in the sixth inning. And Greinke steps off the rubber. Each team with five hits. Dodgers have left five on base tonight. Diamondbacks one. 3-2 Arizona in the sixth. 1-2 to Peterson is launched to right. Tomas leaps over his head up against the fence. And Peterson, who can run, will get to second.
Well, that ball, he went down and got this pitch. Looked like a slider to me. And he drilled a line drive. And Yasmani just could not read it. He didn't know what to do with it, and then lunged for it, and the ball went over his head.
So that's a double. And Peterson in scoring position now for Grandal. Grandal is fly to right. and grounded to Goldschmidt. Hit number six on the night for Los Angeles. Van Slyke is on deck, and you got the pitcher's spot. The Dodgers do have a pitcher up in the pen. A look at the runner. Greinke to the plate. Grandal looks at one outside, 1-0. Oakland winning at home tonight, beating Texas 5-0 in the fourth inning. And Minnesota winning on the road in Anaheim, 4-1 over the Angels in the fourth. Grandal back up the middle, but right at Ahmed. And Nick will throw him out at first base, and on the play, advancing to third base is Peterson. And here's Van Slyke.
And again, it just seems like Zack again in trouble here, but he's got a chance to get out of it. Just a one batter away.
Van Slyke has doubled, and he has popped to first. Howie Kendrick has moved into the on-deck circle to bat for the pitcher if they get there. Kendrick always seems to hurt the Diamondbacks. Greinke out of the stretch. Pitch to Van Slyke is low ball one. I've got the Dodgers 0 for 8 tonight with runners in scoring position. Here's a stretch. Look at third. Van Slyke takes a strike there, 1-1.
And that's exactly what this MLB app has him. 0 for 8.
Yeah. They were 0 for 2 in the first inning, 0 for 2 in the second. 0 for 3 after the first two had gotten on in the third inning. Greinke got back-to-back strikeouts and a pop-up, and 0 for 1 this inning. Greinke trying to make it an 0 for 9. And a chopper foul of the play by Van Slyke, and that's strike two. One ball, two strikes. Remember Ian Kennedy back in 2011, Candy, with runners in scoring position? Oh,
incredible.
Batting average was 130.
138 or 135 or yeah. Something. It's one of the reasons why he won 20 games.
1-2 count on Van Slyke. 3-2 Diamondbacks in the sixth. Greinke's pitch count is at 88 as he works here. Peterson the tying run at third. And Greinke steps off. Castillo, I think, was ready to run out there, but did not do so. Van Slyke stepped out of the box. Now he gets back in. Zack gets his sign from Castillo. Checks Peterson at third base. The 1-2 pitch is down low, 2-2. Well, the Diamondbacks trying to build a little momentum here. They've won the last two ball games. Actually should have won the series, swept that series with the Marlins. But that's over. They won the last two with Greinke out there tonight. You win tonight, you got three in a row. You take a leg up on the Dodgers to start this three-game series. They got a big road trip coming up. 10 games, 2 four-game series, in fact. That's almost unheard of these days. A four-gamer, a two-gamer, and a four-gamer. So they'd like to end this homestand on a bright note and win the homestand. 2-2 pitch to Van Slyke is fouled out of play, first base side. Second level, souvenir. If you're in the neighborhood tomorrow night, come on out, 6:40. Game time. Archie Bradley, Kent Maeda. And then if you're around the ballpark on Wednesday, take your lunch at about 12:30. Come over to the ballpark. Watch some of the Diamondbacks Dodger game. Corbin and Kershaw. The 2-2 to Van Slyke, and it's outside, 3-2 now. The guy on deck, Howie Kendrick, has really hurt the Diamondbacks with his bat since joining the Dodgers. I was shocked he wasn't in the lineup tonight, to be honest with you.
I'm with you on that one, because he just usually tears the Diamondbacks up.
3 balls, 2 strikes. Van Slyke digs in against Greinke. Runner at third, the tying run, the pinch, and it's a little fly ball, shallow center. Segura going out. He runs it down. over-the-shoulder catch by Segura, who runs all the way out to center field and out, crosses over into left center, throws the ball into the bleachers, and heads back for the dugout. Nice catch by Gene, and he keeps the lead in the favor of the Diamondbacks with that running catch. We'll go to the bottom of the sixth, 3-2 Arizona.
Hi, can I have two steak tacos?
Flour or corn?
Oh, no tortillas. And no steak. Also,
is a strike. These two were facing off when Segura tried to steal after driving in the go-ahead run of the fifth inning. Segura was caught stealing to end the inning, so Lamb's up there with a fresh at bat here in the sixth against the lefty. And the 0-1 pitch. And it's grounded down to first. And it's fielded by Gonzalez, who takes it to the bag for the out. Gonzalez was waiting for that ball to come up, and it actually stayed down on him. Now Dave Roberts comes out. We might get a double switch here. Goldie's coming to the plate. They won't allow Howell to face him. Call has been made to the bullpen. Kendrick's also going to come on, probably for Van Slyke, who made the final out. We'll see what happens when we come back. It's 3-2 Diamondbacks in the sixth on the D-backs Radio Network.
Advertising material. If you've been seriously injured, a quick cash settlement may be enticing. But what about the long term? Victims of serious injuries on the job, vehicle wrecks, medical malpractice often suffer lifelong consequences. You need the experience.
Two-thirds of an inning for the left-hander Howell, who would come on a relief of Bolsinger. And Kendrick is in left field. He's in the pitcher's spot, which is the first spot up when the Dodgers hit in the seventh inning against Greinke. 3-2 D-backs. Goldie against Baez. And the first pitch. And Goldie takes upstairs, ball one. Goldie's got that average at 284 and climbing. He has really been on fire.
He really has. How far that average has come up.
Since May 27th, he leads the National League in hitting at 411. Second of the majors. Altuve's hitting 439. Drive to right, down the line. Thompson back, and it is a home run for Goldschmidt. Opposite field. Second of the night. And the Diamondbacks lead it 4-2. He is smoking.
Boy, is he ever. High velocity on the fastball by Baez, and Goldie goes with the pitch the other way and just squeezes it inside the foul pole.
Right down the line. Well, they're going to talk about this, evidently. They're going to take a look and see if it was a fair ball or a foul ball. And by that look there, I'm not too sure. At the moment, it's a run, but we'll see if it's overturned. Jerry Davis is a crew chief. He comes to the headphones along with first base umpire Brian Knight. So this being looked at back in New York. Instant replay brought to you by Wallach & Bullock Mortgage. Let them take a second look at your mortgage options to make sure you're in the right loan at the best rate. Visit secondlook.mortgage for details. Right down the line, we really couldn't tell by our look.
They're going to have to slow it down.
Yeah. You slow it down there. And
look foul.
That looked foul there. Now Goldie would come back to the plate with a strike against him. I believe the count would be 1-1. Baez going through some more warm-up tosses. Well, Goldie is 3 at bat so tonight. Home run to the pool area. Missed a home run to right field. And may have gotten one or may have just missed one here. And they're slowing that down, and I think that is a foul ball. I think I saw the white blend in against the yellow.
The only thing I couldn't tell, though, I couldn't tell if the ball might have hit the foul pole or not.
Now they'll probably take a look at all of that. Call of the field was home run. Jerry Davis has got his hands on his headset like he's ready to take them off. Still listening back there as a review. Well, the one thing we know, Goldie's hot. He's been hot here for a few weeks now. And the Diamondbacks offense is followed in tune. He's looking from the dugout. Doesn't have a helmet on. Might have it in hand, though. Got a little smile on his face like, yeah, maybe I lucked out on one. Nah, maybe they caught me.
I think you're right.
Well, it'd be a big tack-on run if they don't change the call. But the replay we saw, I think they're going to bring him back to the plate. Yeah, foul ball. No home run. So Goldie, who had the helmet in hand, walks back up to the plate. Wonder if a hitter has ever had a home run overturned and then hit one in the same at bat.
We'll see. We got a chance.
Grandal's talking to Baez right now and said, by the way, that's Paul Goldschmidt at the plate. Dave Roberts is in the dugout shaking his head back and forth.
He must not have liked that pitch.
So Baez gets a reprieve here. He'll go up against Goldie on an 0-1 count. One out of the inning. 3-2 Diamondbacks, bottom of the sixth. Out of the stretch. And the pitch. Goldie swings and lines it to right, but foul. Out of play, 1-2 now. These fans are going to poo like crazy if Goldie makes it out. Dodger fans obviously would cheer. He's a tough guy to get out for them. Goldie's now hit 23 career home runs against LA with his home run tonight. 1-2 count. Baez set at the belt. Hard-throwing right-hander is ready. And the pitch to Goldschmidt. Outside and low, 1-2. On deck is Peralta. Diamondbacks have already hit two home runs tonight. We mentioned Goldie's home run. Lamb's hit one. Home run for Corey Seager for Los Angeles. It's a 3-2 Diamondback lead in the bottom of the sixth inning. Goldie trying to get on for Peralta as he digs into the plate. The pitch from Pedro Baez and a chopper foul, third base side.
Back-to-back changeups. Doesn't want to throw him a fastball over the plate anymore.
Smart guy. Miami 8-2 over San Diego in the fourth inning. Oakland now 6-1 over Texas. Detroit 9, White Sox 7. That game's gone to the bottom of the ninth in Chi-Town. Here 3-2 D-backs in the sixth. Goldschmidt at the plate, two balls, two strikes. Baez is ready out of the stretch. And here's a pitch. And he struck him out swinging. And that's out number two. And Goldie takes a quick look out at Baez as he walks back to the dugout. Here's Peralta now. David is one for two, a single to center, and a strikeout swinging, both against Bolsinger. Again, 21,374 the attendance tonight. Game one of this three-game series. Come on out tomorrow night, bring your radio. Come on out Wednesday afternoon. Diamondbacks then will go on that road trip and will not be back home until June 27th. Outside ball one. The Phillies will come into the next homestand along with the Giants and the Padres. It's right before the All-Star break. Diamondbacks will have three final games in San Francisco before the All-Star break. The All-Star game this year is at Petco Park in San Diego on the 12th of July. 1-0 count on Peralta with two down in the inning. Shift is on to the right side. Turner stays on the left side. We'll see if that changes if they get a strike on Peralta. Now time is called. Baez and Grandal can't get together. Grandal shaking his head back and forth. Peralta gets back in. And now Baez is ready. And the 1-0 pitch to Peralta. David swings and misses. Changed up on him. And David way on front. 1-1. Baez is a converted infielder who had some pretty decent numbers in the minor leagues as an infielder. He was an all-star as an infielder, but they liked his arm and converted him into a reliever. And he's been pretty good in that capacity out of their bullpen.
Maybe he'll throw his name in for the pitcher's home run derby.
Why not? Why not, Candy? Foul back by Peralta, who just reached out and slapped that ball. Baez hit 45 minor league home runs from 2007 through 2012. He had 12 1 year, 10 in another season. Hit 286 1 year. Minor league average was 248. Started pitching in 2013. Last year strung out 60 and 51 innings for LA. The 1-2 pitch to Peralta with two out. Struck him out on a high fastball. And this inning is over. Well, Diamondbacks looked like they had a run on a Goldschmidt homer, but was overturned. Called a foul ball. Then by right field. And Tomas moves to left field. Peter O'Brien has left the ballgame. That's Yasmani on left, right, guys? So it is Tomas in left. Board in center. Peralta in right. O'Brien out of the ballgame. Defensively for the Diamondbacks here in this seventh inning. With the Diamondbacks up a run, 3-2. Well, O'Brien would have batted second next inning. They have Bourne in his spot now in the order. All right, Greinke back to work against Howie Kendrick. And Kendrick takes upstairs an inside ball one. Kendrick struggling this season with a .219 average, two homers, 11 runs batted in, but always hits the Diamondbacks. And he fouls this one back. And he's got a very simple approach. Hit the ball the other way. What he tries to do time and time again. And normally is successful in doing it.
Swings a lot like Martin Prado in a way.
Yeah.
Mike's hitting that ball that way.
Last 14 games against the Diamondbacks hitting .345. And he fouls this one back into the press box. Their nightly baseball over there. And the count is 1-2. Mike Ferrin thought we were kidding when we said they get a baseball in there per game, but they do, sometimes two per ball game. So Kendrick leading off here. And then to the top of the order, Utley and Seager against Greinke. And that's low and away. Two balls, two strikes. Well, the hot weather's coming. They're saying 120 this weekend here. You can stay cool this 4th of July under air-conditioned Chase Field. Diamondbacks Padres play at 6:10 and then relax when the roof opens for a post-game fireworks spectacular courtesy of Gila River Casinos. It's truly the best fireworks show in town. Visit dbacks.com. That's another foul ball on the bat of Kendrick. And the count stays 2-2. .32 Diamondbacks leading in the seventh. Trying to strike first in this series against L.A. Hodges just came in from San Francisco last night. 2-2 pitch. Kendrick a chopper foul of the plate. So it's been a long at bat as Greinke battles Howie Kendrick, who spent first good portion of his career with the Angels just south of Dodger Stadium in Anaheim. So again, the defensive alignment for the Diamondbacks. It's Tomas in left, Bourne in center. Peralta in right. O'Brien out of the game. The 2-2 pitch, and it's fouled again by Kendrick. Just can't get that third one by him. Next pitch for Greinke now, Candy, will be number 100.
He's been taxed. It has not been easy for him this game. I can see him get through this inning, though.
Two balls, two strikes on the right-handed hitting Howie Kendrick. Greinke's pitch. Low, ball three, 3-2. Diamondbacks have a pitcher up in the pen. That might be Clippard. It is Tyler Clippard. 3-2 pitch coming up to Kendrick. Greinke's got his sign, goes to work. Here it is, and it's fouled again. Well, you wouldn't expect anything else from Kendrick. Professional hitter. Trying to get on base, waste pitches. Get one he can handle or walk against Greinke, who's not giving in himself.
And he knows his team's down by one run.
This will be the 10th pitch of this at-bat, leading off the seventh inning. And here it comes from Greinke to Kendrick. And a ground ball, right field, base hit. What did I tell you?
What an at bat he slapped on him right there. All those pitches. What was that, the 10th pitch?
10th pitch.
Shoots it through the right side.
Leadoff man on. And now for Chase Utley. Utley 0-for-3 tonight against Greinke. Has not gotten the ball out of the infield. He has struck out and he's twice grounded out. Once to Goldie and once back to Greinke. So Kendrick continues his mastery with that bat of his against the Diamondbacks pitching. One for one tonight. He's at first as a tying run. Utley up there as a go-ahead run. They put a shift on the right side of the infield. Utley taps his bat on the plate. Looks out at Greinke. Looks in to get a sign. Out of the stretch, here's a pitch. And it's a little bit outside. One ball, no strikes.
Got some tough at-bats coming up right now with Utley, Seager, Turner.
Seager and Turner have had exceptional bats against him all night. And they have driven in both of the runs, and Seager has scored both of the runs against Greinke. Zack down 103 pitches, the bullpen heating. Clippert is getting ready all by himself. Kendrick is leading, will draw a throw and get back in without a tag from Goldie. Well, these two teams play, it's usually close. They play a lot of 1-2-run ball games. All right, now it's a one-run game. 3-2 Diamondbacks in the seventh inning. Dodgers about hit the D-backs, 7-5. Greinke to work against Chase Utley on the 1-0 pitch. And Utley slices it foul. Left field side going that way with the pitch, but he fouled it. Count evens at 1-1. Utley, we mentioned all those season with Philadelphia. A lot of great years over there. A six-time All-Star, four-time National League Silver Slugger winner. He digs into the plate. Greinke with Kendrick at first, nobody out. Tying run on base, a pitch. Another foul ball left side as again Utley goes the other way. Fouls it back, 1-2 now.
He almost looks like he's just like Kendrick, but hitting from the left side of the plate.
Well, two veteran hitters to lead off this inning against Greinke. Utley, from 2006 through 2009, was in the top 15 in the NL MVP balloting. He had three seasons with 30 or more home runs, four seasons with 100 or more RBIs, three seasons with 40 or more doubles. Here's a pitch, and that's into the dirt. Count 2-2, and he scored 100 or more runs four different times. And in 2006, had a career-high 35-game hitting streak in which he hit .405 with 9 home runs, 30 runs batted in, 10th longest streak in Major League history. He hit .405 over 35 games. That's
pretty good.
Yeah. Funny, you hear sometimes, he's got a 16-game hitting streak. He's hitting .250. How about 35-game hitting streak where he's hitting .405? Here's a pitch to Utley, and a swing and a foul. He just got a piece of it to stay alive at the plate. And the count is 2-2.
Well, I think Zack recognized that he's trying to hit the ball the other way, so he throws a slider down and in. That is a very difficult pitch to hit the other way.
Seager is waiting on deck, and he's had a good night against Greinke. Single run scored, a walk, and a home run. Zack battling through this one tonight, trying to win his ninth, give the Diamondbacks a three-game winning streak. Leadoff man on against him, though. Kendrick with a single to open the seventh, tying run. The pitch to Utley is down low, and now the count's run full at 3-2.
Well, we knew this was going to be a tough at-bat for Zack. That pitch count's climbing up there. But you just knowing how Utley is approaches his ABs, it's going to be tough.
And Seager has looked anything but a rookie tonight against Greinke. He's on deck. Kendrick is lead. Let's see if Dave Roberts starts the runner. Here's the stretch. He goes. The pitch is lined to left. On comes Tomas. Kendrick puts on the brake, heads back to first, one out of the inning as Yasmani gets it back in. Well, a big out there, a big first stop, and now he's got a guy who's giving him fits all night, Corey Seager.
Well, Utley was trying to hit the ball the other way that whole at bat, but I think he was trying to hit it on the ground. Only one guy on the left side of the infield.
Greinke at 109 pitches. Chip Hale comes out. Has not made a call to the bullpen yet. Hasn't even looked to the bullpen. He goes to the mound here. to ask Greinke what you got for me. Clippard is ready to go if called upon. Greinke at 109 pitches, 71 bench strikes.
Boy, just wants to see, you know, what's left in your tank here.
Yeah.
He's a big part of the order, big part of the game right now. You know, you got to be honest with the manager at that particular time to see, let him know, you know, if you got fuel in your tank.
And he must have plenty in there.
He wants it.
Chip Hale goes to the dugout. Seager steps in. He has singled, walked, and homered. So he scored two. He's driven in one of the two. He's got Kendrick, the tying run at first, with one out here. Zack needs a ground ball double play right about now. Seager has hit into six double plays this year as he stands in. He runs well, out of the stretch ready. And the first pitch to Seager is downstairs. Ball one. Turner next. Turner's had a good night also against Greinke, with a pair of hits and a run batted in. Two runs, seven hits, no errors for the Dodgers. Diamondbacks with an extra run. They've got three, only five hits, no errors in this game. Greinke is ready, and the pitch to Seager is fouled back. Upper level on the third base side, one and one.
Big, powerful cut that time, fouled it off. He was on that.
You know, this kid's already got 15 home runs. You wonder what kind of power numbers he's going to end up putting up in his career.
Ooh.
We're tonight, Diamondbacks are playing game number 66. This is 65 for L.A.
And Seager's off to a slow start.
And a ball inside. Two and one. But his bat has been on fire since late May. He has hit 12 home runs to lead baseball since, what was it, May 20 or May 12th? Corey Seager. That's a strike. Greinke's even the count at 2-2. Since May 11th, he's hit 13 home runs. 13 of his 15, so he went a month, almost a month and a half, Candy, where he only had a couple. He's making up for lost time.
Yeah.
Greinke's gotten even with the count. Two balls, two strikes. Turner on deck. Kendrick at first, a tying run here in the seventh inning. 3-2 D-backs, and now Greinke steps off. Seager backs out, now gets back in. Greinke gets on the rubber, looks in to get his sign. Outfield straight away. Greinke is ready, so is Seager. And the 2-2 is a pop fly. Left field, Tomas should catch it. He's got it. Kendrick tags at first but holds on. He goes back, two down to the inning for Turner. Big second out for Greinke getting Seager.
Another fly ball, another ball up in the air by Zack Greinke. And Tomas runs over there and corrals it in.
That's six fly balls to the outfield tonight. In addition, there have been four fly balls on the infield. Turner has doubled to center, drove in the first run of the ballgame in the first inning. Single to center and fly deep to left against Greinke, and he's been swinging very early in the count. A lob toss to first, and Kendrick gets back. Well, this will be the final inning for Greinke, we're pretty sure. He's at 114 of the pitch count, trying to get through seven and keep the lead at 3-2. Got to get Turner, though. Turner came in here tonight hitting 221. But a 2-for-3 night for him. First one is fouled back, out of play, strike one.
Just like you said, Chase is a slider down and away.
Greinke rubs up a new baseball. Zach's next start will come in Philadelphia on Saturday. Diamondbacks will need a pitcher on Sunday. That could be Shelby Miller, who's got another start in the minors before he comes off the DL. 0-1. The pitch to Turner. In on him. Almost hit him. Knocked him off the plate. A ball and a strike. That'll get your attention as a hitter. You're diving in and that ball's coming right at your elbow. And, ooh, boy, that almost hit his elbow, didn't it?
Certainly did.
One ball, one strike. Greinke is set. Kendrick, who led off the inning with a hit, is at first now. Two men out. The pinch. Strike call, one and two. He must have been thinking maybe slider there or something. Huh, Candy? He took a fastball, looked like right down the middle.
He hasn't been taking anything tonight.
A ball, two strikes on Justin Turner. The Diamondback fans whooping it up here. Trying to get Greinke through seven. 3-2 Diamondbacks leading. Kendrick held on by Goldschmidt. He grabs his lead. Greinke will check him. And the 1-2 pitch to Turner. Ooh, he laid off. Good slider, and he almost chased 2-2. Zack doesn't want to run it full to give Kendrick a head start. So this will be a big pitch for him coming up on 2-2 to Turner.
Pitch number 119 on its way.
Robbie Ray hit, 116 yesterday. 2-2 on Justin Turner. Greinke is ready. Here's the pitch. He struck him out swinging. And Castillo to first for the toss over there on the strikeout. Greinke gets through seven. Keeps the lead. Registers strikeout number six. We'll go to the bottom of the seventh. Baez, 3-2 Diamondbacks lead it. And Castillo tonight is 0 for 2 with two strikeouts. Both those at bats against Bolsinger. And Baez shows him a strike. Let's pause here for a station break. Diamondbacks Radio Network.
KMVP Phoenix, Arizona Sports on 98.7 FM.
Castillo leading off. Michael Bourne will bat next, and then Yasmani Tomas. 0-1 pitch, and that's foul back. And strike two on Castillo. Bourne is in O'Brien's spot in the order. He went into the ballgame into center. Peralta, who started the game in center, switched over to right field, and Tomas, who started in left field, took over O'Brien's spot in left. Castillo leading off, trying to get on base against Baez, who worked a 1-2-3-6 inning with a little scare. Home run that was overturned. It was called foul after a review off the bat of Goldschmidt. Daniel Hudson is in the bullpen getting ready for the eighth inning for the Diamondbacks. Greinke, 119 pitches tonight, 77 strikes. 0-2 on Castillo leading off here. And the pitch to him, and that's slow and away. Our drive of the game, for a quick and easy drive to save with a new Ford, go see Bell Ford. One small step off I-17 and Bell, one giant Ford store. That was going to be the base hit by Segura, get the Diamondbacks the lead in the fifth inning. It wasn't one of the home runs. Made it 3-2, and that's where we stand here in the bottom of the seventh. Diamondbacks trying to make it three straight and three straight at home. And run their record on this homestand even.
Winning streak.
Here's a pinch. Swing and a miss. Castillo has struck out for the third time tonight.
I'm fishing that time for a changeup.
Center field, Michael Bourne.
So one away, and here is Bourne. Evidently, the report on O'Brien, he was fine. It was just a defensive change that was made. Bourne hitting in O'Brien's spot. And he bunts at it and misses strike one. Turner charging from third. Michael, the other night, after Jose Fernandez on Saturday retired the first 17 of the ballgame, that game against Miami, Bourne launched one into right field that went into the seats for a home run. And before the inning was over, the Diamondbacks had gotten four on five hits and taken a 4-2 lead. Again, they won 5-3. Bourne's first home run for the Diamondbacks. He takes outside from Baez, 1-1.
That wall came tumbling down after Bourne got that home run.
Really did. D-backs have been out hit tonight 7-5, but they lead in the run column. The only one that counts 3-2 here. The 1-1 pitch on the way, and Bourne swings and misses. 1-2. An update on the scoreboard there in the bottom of the fifth inning at AT&T. The Giants lead the Brewers 4-3. Amidst rumors that the Brewers and Giants are talking about a trade for Ryan Braun, who's in the lineup tonight for Milwaukee, 1-3. Matt Cain started that game off the DL. Bourne swipes it foul. Almost got Tomas in the on-deck serve. Count stays 1-2. Cain went 3 2/3 innings tonight. 5 hits, 3 runs. Walked 5. Struck out 3. Even though the Giants are winning that game, he can't win it. 1-2. The pitch. Bourne takes high and away. 2-2. What do you want? Bet the count goes 3-2 on Michael Bourne.
Of course it will.
Normally does. He's run it even at 2-2. Tomas on deck, brought to you by Presidential Pools. Build a better life with Presidential. Visit presidentialpools.com. See why they're number one, 25 years and counting. One out, nobody on base. 3-2 in the seventh. D-backs lead the Dodgers. 2-2 to Bourne. Ball three. Full count. So Bourne with his mandatory 3-2 count at the plate. He'll try and get on ahead of Tomas, who's waiting on deck. The Diamondbacks would like another run or two or three or four. They're not going to be picky about it. 3-2 pitch. Bourne walks, ball four. Another great at-bat by Michael Bourne.
Oh, boy. That is your definition of a professional hitter.
You know, the Diamondbacks did damage against Jake Arrieta, but it was the first at-bat of the ballgame by Michael Bourne, a 10-pitch at-bat. He actually struck out to start that ballgame. That really kind of put the wheels in motion against Arrieta that day. Tomas, the hitter, he's 0-2. He's grounded out, and he's fly deep to left. Van Slyke, who was at the game at the time, caught it right near the wall. He'll step in now. Ricky Weeks Jr. has moved into the on-deck circle to bat next for Greinke. Baez ready. That's the first Dodger walk of the night. Throw to first. Bourne gets it back. Bourne has swiped 3. Been caught once. That's a big insurance run to pick up here. Going into the eighth inning. We're in the 7-3-2 Diamondbacks leading. Miami is crushing San Diego tonight. 12-3. The pitch. Strike call. Let's see if Mr. Stanton is doing anything. Well, he is not playing tonight. I'll tell you that. Ichiro's playing. Prado's got a home run. Echeverria's driven in 4 in that game.
They're running all over the bases.
Remember that at bat he had yesterday? It was a 13-pitch at bat. 0-1 count on Yasmani. The pitch from Baez. And it's fouled back on a check swing, strike 2.
High fastball. Looked like he was trying to check his swing. Baez, it seems like he's getting his outs with his changeup. He's got a great fastball, but his changeup is the one he's really attacking with.
So an 0-2 count. That's money. The on-deck hitter, Weeks. One-on-one out here. 3-2 Diamondbacks in the last of the seventh against Pedro Baez. And the pitch. And it's upstairs. 1-2. Andre Ethier made an appearance here today. Mike, you were telling me, what's he? Chrysanthemums?
Chrysanthemums, yeah. He was eating the chrysanthemums to help aid bone healing. I'm not a doctor. Dub, I just play one in the clubhouse.
You're eating chrysanthemums, Candy?
I'm not quite sure what that is.
It's a flower.
What would you eat a flower for?
To help heal bone healing. Here's the 1-2 pitch on the way to Yasmani. A shot to center. Going back on it is Peterson at the wall out there. He leaps. He caught it. And back to first base, hustling to get back over there, and getting back is Michael Bourne. Boy, I tell you what, Mike Peterson can patrol center field. He made a heck of a catch, and it looked like he had it tracked the whole way.
Well, what a terrific play. This ball was really hit hard, deepest part of the field. And it looked like it was going for extra bases. And Peterson, just a great angle, and reaches up with that right arm and just hauls it in right before he crashes into the wall.
Well, his power arrived early last season and then kind of disappeared over the second half. And he has not hit for average. Doesn't steal bases like we were told he would. But his defense has been super sensational since he's got to the major leagues. Here's Ricky Weeks Jr. going to bat now for Greinke. That's another ball crushed by Yasmani. So two outs, Weeks at the plate. Ricky has been used often by Chip Hale. The Diamondbacks manager off the bench is a pinch hitter, and he's done a good job. He's 7 for 28 with four runs batted in. He's hit three home runs. Those have all been in starting roles. Driven in eight. He bats for Greinke, who's out of there after seven innings tonight. Two runs allowed, leading 3-2. First pitch from Baez. Into the dirt, gets away, and down to second goes Bourne. Michael, a wide turnaround second, but hangs on. Baez tugged on that ball.
Man, you get a guy in scoring position now.
Diamondbacks tonight, through six innings, have gone down in order three different times. One, two, three. The other innings where they did not, they scored runs. They scored the first, third, fifth. This is the seventh, so they're in tune to score here, right? It's been every other inning.
Yeah.
They've got that guy in scoring position, a 1-0 count on Ricky Weeks. Bobby Freeman, Diamondback organist, getting the crowd all revved up here. Grandal had a visit at the mound with Baez. Now he goes back behind the plate. And Ricky will step back in with a one ball, no strike count. Ahmed next. 3-2 Diamondbacks leading. Bourne carrying an extra run out at second base if Weeks can get him home. The stretch by Baez. And the pitch. And that's a strike. Good fastball humped in there at 98 miles per hour by Baez.
He's got an electric arm.
Seven hits off Greinke in his seven innings, two runs, struck out six, walked a pair of homer. 119 pitches, 77 strikes. Can win it if the Diamondbacks hang on. And they lead it 3-2 here with two outs in the seventh inning. Weeks is batting for Greinke. Ahmed stretching in the on-deck circle, and now Ricky backs out, takes a practice cut. Ricky's had 72 at-bats now this year. They've gotten him some playing time. More than just pinch hit at-bats.
He's got some interleague games coming up, too.
Yeah. In Toronto, 1-1. The pitch from Baez to Weeks. Here it is. It missed off the inside corner, 2-1. In addition to Ricky's three home runs, he's got five doubles. So eight extra base hits of his 17 hits total. Baez ready. Looks back at second at Bourne. 2-1 pitch to Weeks. Is on the way, and a swing and a miss. 2-2. He's getting that 98 mile per hour fastball, and then he throws a pitch, a changeup, 88 miles per hour, 10 miles per hour slower.
It's a good one, too.
Count evens at 2-2. Get the same pitch here.
I think he's going to go changeup here.
Ricky looking for a two out hit. Trying to get Bourne home with another run. Utley trying to keep Bourne close to the back. Here's a stretch by Baez. And the 2-2, and a line drive center field, but in comes Peterson. He's got it. Boy, Weeks hit that ball hard but out. And the inning comes to an end. Diamondbacks get a walk. They'll leave a runner. We'll go to the eighth. Hudson will come on in relief. 3-2 Diamondbacks over the Dodgers. Hudson replaces Greinke. You want the front seven. And he'll face Gonzalez, the cleanup hitter, Thompson and Peterson. And he comes in with a mark of 1-1. And an earned run average for Daniel of 1.82. 24 and two-thirds innings, only 13 hits. He has given up two home runs. He's walked six, struck out 22, an average against of 149. Gonzalez tonight, Candy, is 0 for 3. He's grounded out, struck out, fly to center.
Getting that first batter out right now is really important in a one-run game.
And it's a ball down low, 1-0. Hudson, first batter efficiency, six hits, a hit batter, an intentional walk. And he's retired 17. So 6 for 23. Gonzalez digs into the plate. And the pitch to him. Swung on and missed. He was late on that fastball. And the count evens out at 1-1. Gonzalez looks like he shed a little bit of weight this year. Looking at him up in that batter's box, he looks a little thinner than years past.
Sometimes Huddy has a tendency to get a little bit underneath this fastball. And he did there. That ball ran up and away, kind of exploded out of the zone.
Here's a 1-1 pitch, and Gonzalez fouls it back. And that one went, I believe, into the...
Somewhere.
I think it went into Oscar and Rodrigo's TV booth. Oscar Soria and Rodrigo Lopez. I think it went in and out of their booth over there. 1-2 count on Gonzalez leading off here. Hudson ready, and the pitch popped up. Backing out is Abed, the shortstop, shallow left field. He's got a one out.
Boy, nice pitch that time by Huddy. Just runs the fastball in on his hands. The other two were a little bit up, a little bit away. Then he comes inside and makes Gonzalez bring his hands in. He can't do anything with it.
Here's Trace Thompson, who has walked tonight, struck out and flied out to center. Trace Thompson. And I believe his brother's team, the Golden State Warriors, were beaten tonight by the Cleveland Cavaliers. So no championship yet for the Warriors. I'll go back to Cleveland. 3-2 Golden State leading. Fastball, but it misses outside from Hudson. One ball, no strikes.
The bats we've seen with Thompson tie against Zack have been very patient.
Yeah.
But he's shown he's been very selective.
Their two kids, Seager and Thompson, look like veteran hitters at this point of their career. 1-0 pitch from Huddy, and that's a strike, 1-1. They've got a shift on the left side against Thompson. That means Goldie's all by his lonesome over on the right side of the infield. Thompson walked in the first, struck out swinging in the third, fly to center in the sixth inning. 3-2 Diamondbacks in the eighth, and Hudson tugged on that one, misses way outside, 2-1. Milwaukee's come back. They've tied that game with San Francisco at 4 in the sixth inning today. Well, maybe the Brewers can beat the Giants, Diamondbacks can beat the Dodgers, and Diamondbacks can gain a game. Diamondbacks right now, though, they just need to worry about trying to get back to 500 and then go from there. A foul back, and that got somebody. Castillo or the umpire, I'm not sure, but it's a foul ball, 2-2. Jack Peterson is on deck. Tomas is really deep in left. He did not start the game in left field. He started in right field. Hudson has his sign on 2-2 to Trace Thompson. Here's the pitch. And a chopper foul off his foot up the third baseline.
Good fastball coming inside tight on him. This guy's tough to pitch to.
Yeah.
I'm not quite sure about him yet. But Hudson does such a nice job mixing his pitches up, just like Zack Greinke did.
Two balls, two strikes. Hudson got the first out. Gonzalez on a pop-up. And now the 2-2 to Thompson is lined foul down the right field line out of play again. Really making honey work here. In Oakland tonight, the A's have come up with a 14-2 lead over the Rangers in the bottom of the fifth. They got four in the third inning, five in the fourth. They've scored four, still batting in the fifth inning. They've got 17 hits in less than five innings in that game. 2-2 to Thompson is fouled back again. This kid's really battling Hudson.
Really is. He took that ball right out of Castillo's glove. Fouled it off.
Two balls, two strikes with one out. A one-run Diamondback lead here, 3-2 in the eighth inning. Hudson against Thompson. 2-2 pitch. Ball three. Full count. Thompson with another good at bat. And he definitely doesn't want to walk him.
And he's got speed also. He can run.
He swiped four bases. Trace Thompson. A Dodger right fielder. 3-2 pitch from Hudson, and it's inside. He walked him, and Huddy really mad at himself, yelled at himself after delivering that ball. There's a tied run on base now for Jack Peterson.
I think he just kind of flew open that time. He's upset, but really tip your hat to Thompson on that one. He put a really good at bat on him. He made him battle.
He's walked twice in this game. Here's a guy you got to be careful of, Jack Peterson. Explosive power. Tonight he is fouled out to Lamb, the third baseman. Popped up to Ahmed, the shortstop around the mound area. And doubled to right field on a ball over Tomas's head. He's hit nine home runs on the air. Thompson is lead at first. He's the tying run with one out against Hudson. And the pitch to Peterson runs inside with a fastball, ball one. And Castillo calls time and runs to the mound. And also Ahmed's going to come in, the lone fielder on the left side of the infield.
Huddy's got some good numbers against him. He's 0 for 3. Not a whole lot of ABs. But like you said, this kid's just a dangerous player.
In that Oakland game, Candy, 14-2, Chris Davis, who grew up and played high school ball here in the Valley, has homered and driven in five of those 14 runs for the A's tonight.
Chris with the K.
Yeah. The other Chris Davis is sending a lot of long balls, too, these days.
He's on fire.
One with a CH. Baltimore. One ball, no strikes. Conversation was brief between catcher and pitcher. Hudson ready. Thompson is lead. He is the tying run. The pitch to Peterson is down low, 2-0. Randall is next. Huddy getting himself into some trouble here. When he pitched in the ball game on Saturday night, it's the first time he'd worked in a week. So now he is on the mound 2 days later. He got Gonzalez on a soft pop-up, but then walked Thompson on a 3-2, and he's 2-0 on Jack Peterson. The 2-0 pitch from Hudson, and that's a strike. Nice changeup, and a good one for Huddy to get it over 2-1.
Yeah, and that's a nice pitch because he's a pretty aggressive hitter. He's not a guy that is really going to make you throw a strike. He's up there to swing the bat. It's a nice pitch, even though he didn't offer after it.
So Hudson with a 2-1 count on Peterson. Holds the bat up high. Time is called. And Peterson backs out. And tomorrow night, Archie Bradley and Kenta Maeda in the 640 game. 2-1 the count here. Hudson to Peterson. Ball three, almost hit him. 3-1. He had to jump out of the way. How do you dial up a double play ball here? Get yourself out of trouble.
Well, he'll be in swing mode right here.
Oh, yeah.
Changeup would be a good pitch, I think.
Again, the right side of the infield stacked with three fielders. Ahmed alone on the left side. Peterson, a left-handed batter. The lead by Thompson. 3-1 to Peterson, and he walked him ball four. And a back-to-back walks there. Now the Dodgers really in business with two on and one out of the inning. And that means a visit from Mike Butcher, the pitching coach. Hudson's got himself into real trouble here.
Yeah, 18 pitches he's thrown now, and nine balls, nine strikes. He just hasn't quite got that feel yet.
Grandal tonight is 0 for 3. He's flied out and twice grounded up. Slow foot. You can get him to hit it on the ground. You can get him in a double play. He's hit into four this year and 131 at bats. Arizona Diamondback fans, fill out your 2016 Esurance MLB All-Star Game ballot. You can do that now at dbacks.com on your computer, your tablet, or your smartphone. Vote up to 35 times. Vote today. Vote tomorrow at dbacks.com/vote. Trouble of brewing here. Diamondbacks get the bullpen going. Zack Curtis, the left-hander, will be joined by, I believe, Brad Ziegler down to the bullpen. Two on and one out on back-to-back one-out walks from Hudson.
I think the Dodgers have any lefties coming off their bench.
Here's the stretch and the pitch, and that's down low, ball one. On deck is Kike Hernandez, a right-handed hitter. That's all they have on the bench. They've used Kendrick. They've got Barnes, Ellis, and Hernandez. They got their left-handers in the lineup tonight. Hudson 1-0 on Grandal, the switch-hitting catcher for the Dodgers. The pitch to him. That's a little bit low, 2-0.
Really struggling with the changeup to field. Usually that changeup is right there for him all the time. And along with his fastball.
Boy, watch it here on a 2-0 count. Grandal will be looking for one pitch. And he can drive. Hudson needs to throw a strike. He's walked both Thompson and Peterson with one out of the eighth inning. The tying and go-ahead runs on base. A 3-2 Diamondback lead. That's a strike, 2-1. He hit that changeup in, and Grandal didn't buy it. He turns around, looks into his dugout. Dave Roberts yelling at home plate umpire Carlos Torres.
I thought he might be swinging right there, 2-0. It was a good pitch.
And Torres just put his hand up and said enough is enough. 2-1 count now. Ahmed, the shortstop, almost playing straight up the middle against Grandal. 2-1 from Huddy. Ball three.
Well,
one wide right here loads him up.
Well, with the slider down and in, Grandal showing some patience.
Kike Hernandez is next. Hudson needs to make some kind of a pitch right here on 3-1 or load him up.
Ziegler really getting loose down there.
The pitch. He walked him and they're loaded. Back to back to back walks with one out of loaded one for the Dodgers in the eighth inning. And Kike Hernandez, right-handed batter, will come off the bench and pinch hit.
Well, I think if Ziegler's ready, this is the time to bring him in right now because you need that ground ball double play.
Hernandez runs pretty well. He's a right-handed hitter. Here comes Chip Hale. And he'll walk out there and give Ziegler some more pitches if he needs them. Hernandez, a 205 average, 4 home runs, 11 runs batted in. He's been announced as a pinch hitter. Huddy leaves. Ziegler will come on and try and get. All right, it's Brad Ziegler called upon to try and do what he does best, get that ground ball double play. He will face Kike Hernandez off the bench as a pinch hitter with the bases loaded, one out, eighth inning, and a 3-2 Diamondback lead. Ziegler trying to get five outs here tonight. Doug Peterson just running out of the dugout. He was in the dugout as Ziegler was warming up. He heads out to second. The runner at third base is Thompson. Grandal's at first. They all walked in this inning against Hudson. who leaves him loaded for Ziegler. Tough spot to come in on.
How about a comebacker right now? Just first one pitch, get a comebacker.
Hernandez, bat held high. First pitch from Ziegler is a strike call, 0-1. On deck, it's Kendrick. That's why I like the double play ball here.
Right now.
High back infield, look for that double play ball. Ziegler, 104 of them since he came up to the big leagues in 2008. His 0-1 pitch, swing and a miss on the Frisbee slider, strike two.
Nice pitch. Got that right where he needed to, right on the outside corner.
So Ziegler with an 0-2 count on Kike Hernandez. Bases full of Dodgers. Eighth inning, a one-run Diamondback lead, 3-2. Brad looks in, gets a sign from his catcher, Castillo. Got the one he wants. The 0-2 pitch. Here it is. He struck him out swinging to the slider again. Two outs in the inning. Hernandez had no chance of that at bat against Ziegler.
Just another great Frisbee. Starts off the plate and keeps breaking away. He couldn't have hit that if he's had a 38-inch bat in his hand.
Now here is the veteran, Howie Kendrick. Kendrick's had one at bat tonight. He's got a single to right field. He'll face Ziegler now. Now two outs in the inning. The pitch. And the Frisbee slider misses outside, ball one. Kendrick laid off. At third base, Thompson, he walked. Peterson walked. He's at second. Grandal walked. He's at first. Two men out. Eighth inning. 3-2 D-backs leading the Dodgers. Ziegler in relief of Hudson. The 1-0 pitch to Kendrick. Swing and a miss. 1-1.
Ooh, he's got that Frisbee working in this game. Another good one.
Well, Ziegler has even the count of ball and a strike on Kendrick. Crowd making a ruckus here. The stretch. The 1-1. And did he go? He did. Strike two on Kendrick. The call made by the home plate umpire, Carlos Torres.
This ball was a good foot and a half, maybe 2 feet outside. And he still offered after it.
One ball, two strikes. One and two is the count. They put 2-1 on the board. It's 1-2. And Carlos Torres trying to get the scoreboard operator to correct it. They do, and you can hear the crowd. Two outs. Bases loaded for the Dodgers in the eighth. Diamondbacks up a run. Ziegler in relief here. Crowd up on its feet. Ziegler's got his sign. Here's the pitch. And a shot to center. Michael Bourne comes in. He's got it. Bourne with a head dive catch. And the Diamondbacks get out of the inning. And Ziegler comes in and does the job with a strikeout and a line drive out. And the Dodgers have left him loaded. Nice job by Ziggy, who's still got the ninth, the pitch, but the Diamondbacks keep the lead. We'll go to the bottom of the eighth, 3-2 Arizona. Has reached on a fielder's choice, stole a base, scored a run. That was a go-ahead run, knocked in by Segura in the fifth inning. Off the end of the bat to first. Backspin on it. Gonzalez knocked it down, picks it up, and gives it to the new pitcher, Luis Coleman, at the bank for the out to retire Ahmed on one pitch here, one out in the eighth. You could see that ball had a lot of backspin. That's probably the worst fear for any infielder, that backspin, and you're trying to feel which way that ball's coming to him, and hit off his glove and fell out.
You don't know which way it's going to bite.
And the thing of it is, to the regular baseball fan out there, it looks like a routine play. And then that fielder is just hoping that he can knock it down and pick it up and get the out they did. Luis Coleman is the new pitcher now. Baez worked a couple of innings, struck out three, walked a man, nothing else. Here's Segura. Time was called by Grandal. Gene drove in the third run of this ball game for the Diamondbacks in the fifth inning. That was a go-ahead run in the fifth inning. And it stayed that way since the fifth. He bats down the eighth. There's the stretch by Lejolin, and now he backs off. Diamondback fans starting to rev it up. Dodgers had a great opportunity in that eighth with the three walks. But Ziegler came in and shut the door. Breaking ball strike to Segura. Or as they put on the board up there, a fastball at 82 with bite on it. 0-1 count. Segura's RBI was his 29th of the season. And Coleman, who comes sidearm and misses outside 1-1. Boy, he starts on that first base side of the rubber, then he really crosses over, and he's way over on the third base side of the mound when he brings that ball in. And a check swing. Segura. Now he's into the point game. He pointed down to the first base umpire, Brian Knight. Carlos Torres, home plate umpire, said, I don't have to point. You swung.
Yeah, he already called it before Gene did that.
1-2. The phone lights are flickering here at the ballpark. 1-2 pitch to Segura. Way outside. It's 2-2. You can see where this guy could be trouble against right-handed hitters. His motion. Luis Coleman used to be with Kansas City.
Yeah, a lot of movement, a lot of angle.
Coleman comes in here 0-1, a 2.84 ERA, 29 games, 25 innings, only 14 hits, struck out 24, but he's walked a dozen. And Segura takes low, 3-2 now, full count on him. Lamb is next. Diamondbacks have been out hitting this game 7-5, but they're up a run 3-2 in the eighth. Trying to strike first in the series. Coleman ready, Segura ready. With one out, here's the 3-2 pitch. And a ground ball back up the middle center field base hit. I don't know how that didn't hit Coleman. I think he's wondering the same thing.
Yeah, he wasn't in good fielding position. If he was, he might have had a better chance of trying to catch this ball. A nice swing by Segura. This ball was inside, and somehow he's able to get it up the middle. Front door slider. Coleman really falling off towards first base side. Couldn't make a play.
Dave Roberts going to go get his other lefty. Adam Liberatore is going to come in, replacing Coleman, who got an out, gave up a hit. Take a break. Eighth inning, 3-2 Diamondbacks on the D-backs radio network. 26 of 27 games. He's 1-0 with an 0.92 ERA. 13 consecutive scoreless games since May 20th. He's stranded 17 of 21 inherited runners. A 191 batting average against, 125 average for lefties against him. They're only 5 for 40. Lamb 1 for 3 tonight with a home run. That was against Bolsinger in the third. Adam Liberatore.
And this will probably be the only batter he faces.
Here's a stretch and a throw to first. Segura gets back in. Segura just got the Diamondbacks' sixth hit of the night. That'd be a big run to pick up here. Liberatore, 6'3", 240. He's every bit of that. Selected by Tampa, 21st round back in 2010. And the Dodgers got him in a deal with the Rays in 2014. Another throw to first. Another bag again. 39 games with the Dodgers last year, a 4.25 ERA. Lamb's home run tonight is 12th of the season. Now 39 runs batted in. He and Goldie both tied with the home run lead on the team. Goldie hit one tonight. Here's the stretch and the pitch. And Lamb almost hit by that pitch. Just did get out of the way at the last second. 1-0 the count.
Almost dove into that one. Don't want to do that.
Looking ahead of the ninth inning for the Dodgers, the top of the order, Utley, Seager, and Turner against Ziegler. 3-2 D-backs. Segura held on by Gonzalez. And the pitch. And that's up and in. Lamb has to duck out of the way, 2-0.
That's two fastballs, not even close. You got to take a strike here. Make this guy throw a strike.
Lamb looks down at Matt Williams, the third base coach. Dave McKay over at first. Diamondbacks trying to make it three straight wins here at home. and take a 4-3 lead in this home stand with two to play. 2-0 count on Jake Lamb. Time is called by the catcher again, Grandall. We've seen that several times tonight. Grandall's called time on his pitcher when he's been ready to work. I think Baez one time was in his motion going to the plate and time had been called by Grandall. And now we're ready. And the 2-0 pitch to Lamb is coming. Inside, almost hit him again. 3-0.
Well, 2-0, Grandall still giving the fastball sign, but he wants it inside. And you got a guy that's not even close with the first two pitches. He's not going to dot the inside corner there. That almost dotted Lamb.
Lamb twice has had to jackknife out of the way on pitches from Liberatore. 3-0 count. There's a strike, 3-1. Segura with one out, singled back up the middle. And that was it for Coleman. He got one out, one hit. Now Lamb against the lefty. They have a right-hander getting ready for Goldschmidt, who's on deck. Lamb digs in. And the 3-1 pitch coming. That's a strike, 3-2. That's gone full. We'll see if Segura runs. He was caught stealing back in the fifth inning with Lamb at the plate.
I don't think he runs here, especially with Goldie up next.
Yep. Lamb against lefties has struggled some. Liberatore against lefties has been outstanding. And now Lamb asks for time and backs up. Three balls, two strikes. Segura takes a walking lead off first. Outfield straight away for Lamb. Liberatore is ready. Grandall sets up outside. And the 3-2 pitch is on the way. And a foul back to the screen. Good job there by Jake. Wasting the pitch. Stays 3-2. Lamb now with his three at-bats tonight, 209 at-bats on the year. 55 hits. And 30 of those have been extra base hits, including a dozen home runs, 16 doubles, a pair of triples. 3-2 count. The pitch on the way, and that's ball four. He walked him. And two on, one out for Goldschmidt. Grandall thought they had a strike, as did Liberatore. But Lamb will draw the walk, and for Jake, that's his 26th walk of the year.
You know, if they wanted that one, they're begging. That was a slider, and it was way up in the zone. Can't call that a strike.
Dave Roberts makes the call to the bullpen. This might be Blanton coming on. Kind of looks like him. He's been outstanding out of their bullpen. And we'll take a break. 3-2 Diamondbacks, two on for Goldie when we come back on the Diamondbacks. What will be the batter with two on, one out of the eighth inning, a 3-2 Diamondbacks lead. Goldie's homer tonight. Fly to the fence in right field, caught by Thompson. And then after being given a home run down the right field line on a replay, they determined it was a foul ball. Ended up striking out of the sixth inning. But he could add two home runs. Actually, could add three home runs tonight. But he's got one. He's trouble for the Dodgers, always has been. And Blanton will face him, the right-hander here. Two on and one out. 3-2 Diamondback lead. Blanton's been good. 143 batting average against. 16 hits and 112 at-bats. First pitch is in for a strike, 0-1. Blanton, a former starter, has really found life in the bullpen. Righties hit him at 164. Lefties, 4-for-39 against this guy, 103. He's just been lights out when he's come into a game for Dave Roberts. The 0-1 to Goldie. Outside and low. One ball, one strike. Well, he's figured it out, can't he, and resurrected his career.
Well, he's thrown two pitches now. The first one was a good curveball. 12-6 break, gets in there. Second pitch was a changeup. Had good movement. He kept it down.
Well, he's got Segura at second, Lamb at first. Single and a walk could put them there. One out here, eighth inning. And that's down low, 2-1.
Another changeup.
You can just tell the difference in Goldschmidt these days with his at-bats, just the way he's spitting on pitches that 3 or 4 weeks ago he was swinging at.
It just kind of slows down for you. You see the ball a lot better.
Bland now 35 years old out of Gallatin, Tennessee. 2-1, he's falling behind Goldschmidt. The pitch. Strike, 2-2.
Borderline there.
It's been an interesting zone tonight for home plate umpire Carlos Torres.
This ball looked down and away to me.
It was. Bland's been with the A's, the Phillies, the Dodgers, the Angels, the Royals, the Pirates, and back with the Dodgers. He looks in to get his sign. Two on, one out, 2-2 count on Goldschmidt. The pitch. And a ground ball back up the middle. Seager's got it. He'll flip to Utley and then back to first. And that's a double play. And the inning is over. 6-4-3. And the Diamondbacks are done here in the eighth inning. They'll go to the ninth, though. The bases loaded, one out of the eighth inning. Struck out the pinch hitter, Kike Hernandez, and then got Howie Kendrick, who lined one to center. Bourne came in and made a diving catch. A head first catch. So it's Utley, Seager, and Turner in the ninth for L.A. 3-2 Diamondbacks leading. First one to Utley is off the plate. Ball one, 1-0.
Yeah, not too many times you say this is the fifth time through the order in a 3-2 game.
Not very often. That's what's happened here. Dodgers have 7 hits. They've received 5 walks in the game. That's fouled back by Utley, 1-1. Utley tonight is struck out looking, tap back to the bomb, grounded to first, fly to left field. That all-important first hitter here in the ninth inning was Seager next. Seager's got a home run tonight. He scored both of their runs. One ball, one strike. Chase Utley against Brad Ziegler. The pitch outside, 2-1. Giants leading the Brewers 5-4. They're at bat at the bottom of the seventh inning in San Francisco. San Diego getting crushed tonight, 13-4 at Petco by the visiting Marlins in the eighth. The 2-1 to Utley. And a ground ball to the right side. Segura's got the big hop. Runs to Goldie. Flips him the ball for the out, one away. Big first out.
Nice pitch by Brad. Gets hit right on the top of the ball. An easy ground ball to Gene Everett, second base.
Shortstop, Corey Seager.
Seager tonight has singled and scored. He has walked, he has homered, and he's flied to left field. Corey Seager. You've seen him in the two spot in the batting order these days, but it won't be long before he'll be hitting third. Or maybe they'll leave him too. Depends upon what they have around him. There's a ball outside, 1-0. All I know, he's going to be a big part of their offense for a long time.
Well, you're not kidding.
One out of the ninth, Ziegler's pinch. And that misses away, 2-0. Turner's next. Diamondbacks only 6 hits tonight. But they took the lead with a run in the fifth inning. They're trying to see if that holds true here in the ninth. There's a strike to Seager, 2-1. Greinke went the front 7 innings, allowed 7 hits, 2 runs. Struck out 6, walked a couple, gave up a homer. The 2-1 pitch to Corey Seager. And it's grounded right at Ahmed. It's short on a tough hop. He's got it and throws to first for the out, 2 down. He got him to reach. That ball took a little hop there, kind of a funny hop on Ahmed at the last second, Candy, but he stuck with it.
And I don't think this ball was hit as hard as it looked off the bat. I think that's why it had that extra hop to it.
2 outs. Here's Turner, who has doubled homer run tonight, singled, fly to left, and struck out. Diamondback fans on their feet, hoping for a win here. And wins against the Dodgers have not been plentiful over the years. And Turner steps in, Gonzalez next, Ziegler waits for Turner. And his first pitch to Turner is a breaking ball in there for a strike on one.
I'd throw this guy all frisbees. Just like he kind of pitched Kendrick. His frisbees on the outside part.
Ziegler looking for save number 13. The 0-1 to Turner. And that misses inside. One ball, one strike. You'd rather have the guy on deck stay there. Gonzalez in this game in. Right here. Ziegler is ready on the 1-1 pitch. Ground ball back to the mound. Ziegler's got it. On to Goldie. High, but out. The game is over, and the Diamondbacks win it. A little excitement there at the end. Goldie went up. Came down with the foot of the bag of the Diamondbacks. Candy won a one-run game. They beat the Dodgers here tonight, 3-2.
You know, this is really a hard-fought game. It's, you know, Zack Greinke probably didn't have his best stuff, but he made the pitches when he had to. In fact, I think the Dodgers were 0-11 with runners in scoring position. So all the pitchers came in, and really to the bullpen, Ziegler coming in, you know, getting the first batter that he faced in a way that he really needed to do it after Huddy had walked, the bases loaded. I mean, just a tremendous game.
So the Diamondbacks get a win here tonight. We'll have a guess down to the field momentarily, and we'll see who that is. Greinke gets a win, his ninth of the season. And Bolsinger suffers a loss. Ziegler, his 41st consecutive save.